Of course, the first two fucking people to request off me when I get in VR chat is it's Carno and Vincent.
Hold on. Right, all right, all right. We're live. Check.
Okay. I just got live too.
Okay, where's something with us?
There we go.
All right, can you see everything? You should be able to hear background music too, right?
I do, but let me get my Windows set up right so I can that. There we go. I'll make this a little smaller. I don't.
Just hold Yo, how do you suck this guy off? Tell me you miss me
while All right. I'm
alone and blue as can be.
Dream of All right, I think we're good.
All right, let me see your stream and make sure everything looks and sounds good. Yeah, everything looks it's a little bit stretched, I think. Let me see. Nah, I think it looks all right actually. It should be fine.
But if it's stretched, let me just think. That means I have it too deep that way, right? So I need to do the opposite. Yeah, it does look a little stretched. So that means then I need to go up.
There you go. If you just make it a little more wide, I think that's perfect. Oh, that looks so much better.
Yeah, make it a little more wide, you said?
I think what you changed was good. Whatever you did on stream was really good.
Yeah, all right, good.
Why am I faking? Because my real avatar is fucking underboob. You fucking idiots. I'm going to get in trouble.
Welcome all. Welcome. I'm doing my first visit to DR chat. Raffle Gator gonna show me around. I'm looking forward to it.
All right. Mr. Clancy, there is one very important thing that we need to go over.
All right.
So my chat has this thing called like the normie check, right? And it's like when people call me Raffle Gator, it means they don't really know me because most people call me Rob on right. Twitch. So we're gonna have to be on a first name basis or else my stream's gonna think you're a normie, which is not a good thing in my community. Right. So Rob is okay.
Well,
yeah,
I
you don't want
to
be.
First of all, I'm conditioned when I meet people not to use their first name because some people don't use their first name on Twitch.
True. True.
And then I'll like go and I'll be streaming with them and I'll say so and so and like I don't use my name in Twitch. So if I'm gonna air, all right, Rob, that's much better. Raffle Gator is a mouthful anyway.
I hate that name. I want to eventually change it. Like I made this name when I was like 13 years old. But now it's just kind of stuck with me. Like I want to eventually change it. I just can't.
All right. Well, let's see who's hanging out in here. Should we go say hi to folks?
Well, so far it's just you and me. I'm gonna invite some people in a second. All right. I didn't want to invite too many people right away because we're gonna do like our little TOS interview in a second.
Yeah, I know.
But after that a bunch of people will join.
So let's tell everyone what we're gonna be doing. So in fact, we're gonna start where I Rob wanted to ask me some with chat about some TOS questions and other things. So we're gonna talk about the TOS a little bit. Then we will start wandering around VR, the VR chat world, and Rob's gonna show me some of the cool stuff going on. So for those in my chat that have not watched VR chat, it'll be your chance to experience, and maybe we'll end with some music or something like that. But I'm bored to hanging out in VR chat.
Yep, and guys. Mr. Clancy is streaming too. What do you want me to call you, Dan? Do you want me to call you Mr.
Dan.
Clancy, DJ Dan? Okay.
No, really, let's
I feel like I should be proper,
Mr.
you know?
No. Because then everyone in my chat's going to think that, you know, I don't even know what they're going to think you are.
Then I'm going to be the normie.
Mr. Clancy. Yeah, worse than the normie. I don't know what it is. I don't know. Literally, nobody calls me Mr. Clancy. So I can't even say who calls me Mr. Clancy.
Oh,
so,
God. I'm not even normie.
You can call me. Yeah, you can call me Dan. That works. That's what
okay.
Everyone calls me. Nobody calls me DJ. So Dan works, Rob.
Guys, Dan is streaming too, so if you want to go in there and harass him in chat, you can do that as well. I know he reads his chat. He'll check it out. He'll look at it. So you can go mess with him as well in there. No, Chad, I don't think he's related to Tom Clancy. That's the question I get the most whenever I say that I'm going to...
I do have an Uncle Tom Clancy who's a sculptor, but that is not the Tom Clancy they all know. So,
It's so funny because whenever I told everyone that I'm doing a one-on-one with Dan Clancy, they're like, wait, the Splinter Cell guy? And I'm like, no, he's our freaking CEO, guys. Like, how do you guys not know this yet? But, here's what's on the agenda for today, guys. We're going to first do the interview, like, about TOS stuff, okay? I don't know how long we're going to go into that. Probably not, like, super long. We're going to try to get a little bit of... a little bit of clearance on everything, because I know a lot of people are confused about TOS stuff. And then, oh look, there's a hobbit here. One of your people have come.
All right. You need to. Oh my gosh, there's a hobbit there.
Well, you are Gandalf. Do you want to sit next to him?
What do I do to wave my hand?
So you can press R, and then when you press R. There is an expression, so you could do like expressions, and then somewhere there, depending on the avatar, there's going to be, here, let me look at your stream and maybe I could, yeah, you just did it.
I'm not saying, so there's not like a keystroke?
No, unfortunately, because it's avatar dependent. Every avatar has different gestures, yeah. So it's completely dependent on that.
Let me just see. Oh, by the way, I'm looking at your stream. Let me just look now. Okay. So there. Okay, there. I'm waving my sword, which seems a little aggressive there, but, you know, so be it. All right. And so what did I... Let's see. And then I hit escape to get out of this?
Or back? Yeah. Or you can just press R again as well.
R. It was R. R opens that. So R. Okay. And expressions and emojis. Got it. All right. Got it.
Should I kick out Karna?
Happy Friday, John Lee. All right.
Oh, our drinks are here. Thank you, Allman. So, yeah, this is like full body tracking in VR. Like, Allman uses full body tracking. And so, remember how I told you there was a lot of mutes? Allman is someone who is actually a mute, but they do occasionally have like an AI voice. Like, AI voices are really popular in this game where it like... It'll track your voice and then change it into like a different voice that you can like record or pre-program or whatever. But there's also like a really big sign language community in this game as well.
Nice.
This is my friend Snape, by the way.
I know. And however, that, now, but they all have. Why do you have Rob? Why do you have Rafflegator as opposed to Rob? And why does Snape? Can't you change? I guess it's Murder Crumpet, and right now he's Snape. Got it.
Okay. I am now doing a voice. Yes.
Yeah, it's one to allows. I can play with a wand. Right.
I thought this was Saruman. Wonderful.
You've had wonderful. RP lessons,
wizard,
right?
Wizard.
How good is
lessons,
your RP?
I just did it.
Can you act as this?
But I was quite good at it, huh?
Okay, let's see your role play. Like, let's do some role play right now. That'd be all a right. good little thing. All right. So from now on, we are role playing in this instance. All right. This is now a role playing instance.
All right. I have to work. The thing is, I have to work on my gun. I will. Let's see. You shall not pass. I need to get my Gandalf voice down a little.
I felt it. That was quite intense.
But I need to get my Gandalf voice down. All right, now.
Dude, we're at a diner. We're at a diner, dude. You're being kind of loud. Right. You're offending the people behind you.
That's okay. But my name is Gandalf. So I am going to be loud sometime.
Gandalf, could you take care of the man at the bar? He's causing me an issue. He seems rather familiar to you. Maybe a Balrog.
Balrog.
Please, where's the Balrog? Oh my gosh, there's a Balrog there. Now, how do I take care of that Balrog? Now, I don't know the controls. Do I need to get up and then go over to him? Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir. What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? I'm going to drink some coffee and some pizza pack. It's like...
Are you
Did he actually do you plan for him to RP with Vincent when you were kind of scoping this out?
I did not expect this.
I'm dying.
As long as you're here not to cause trouble, if you just want to drink tea, I will have tea with you.
I like
How
tea.
Do I have some tea?
Making peace with the Balrog. Tea?
What do I need to do to get some tea?
Well, you can come here and order some. We do have a booth.
All right.
Yeah, I got to.
All right.
Come on back. You've disarmed the Balrog. It was an excellent work.
Yes.
Remind me how I sit down.
You've been sitting this whole time. You've actually been crouching around everywhere.
Oh, that's very odd. How do I stand up then?
You press the C button again, and then it'll let you stand.
The C.
Ooh, watch it. You got a big sword there, buddy.
Sword drawn. Careful.
Hey, that's what they all say.
All
I'm
right, sure.
This is much better.
Like serious voice.
Can we get some? Right, can we get some tea, right. please?
Can I get a?
Yes, thank you.
Voice right now.
Can I get a Coke Zero?
Oh, thank you.
Can I get a cheap?
Wizard to wizard, I've always admired your work.
Well, thank you, thank you. My ideas too.
Did you order anything?
You're quite the inspiration for all wizards out there. All
right.
Wait, they did.
And now I hold to grab. Yeah, there we go. And now I hit M and I can grab it. Is that what I do?
You click it. You click it.
Click and hold, all and right. It'll be yours.
Oh, but I don't. There we go. Now
there you
I'm holding it, right?
Yeah, you are holding it. Well, you actually put it in the table.
Yeah, I got you.
Oh, well, that's silly.
We actually brought you a date. No, Vray, can you help him with his drink, please, Vray?
His magical ability is next level. He put that cup straight through the table.
Put it on my tab.
Now I did it again.
Look, he did it again.
Vray, could you help him out?
Coke Zero? You're pouring Coke.
Oh, okay, so there's something...
Oh, now I see. Now I've got it.
If he shows you...
Oh, this is so simple.
Vray, if he shows you, are you going to load in like that? Like, are you going to load in safely? Okay. So one thing you have to do, some people's avatars might not show. Do you know how to fix safety settings? Cause I have no clue. I've done this stuff like 50 years ago. Okay. Can you teach him?
So yeah, if you want to fix your safety settings, you just hit escape and then you press small shield in the bottom right corner and it's change shield level and you're pretty safe with us here. So you can just click none. On the shield level, and that should allow you to see everybody.
Let me go meet one of
the sure, friends. I'm safe with you here.
Hopefully.
I mean, you are a powerful wizard. I would be remiss,
I've heard that
remiss
one
to believe.
Before, and next thing you know, you're going to try to turn me into a toad.
It's a very real possibility. Newts are a popular spell of mine to cast.
Tell me this. Tell me this. The tea is hanging
this is
in
happening.
The air. Aaron, I thought it said right mouse button to set it down. But
you have to
seem to be doing it anymore. Yeah.
You have to actually move it around, okay? And then you have to set it however you want.
It's a magic thing. As you can see, a little levitation
right.
is common in this town.
Oh, now I see. Alrighty, and I put it a little bit below. Alright, it's nice. I have your stream going.
A couple mugs just for the road. Just get some
alrighty. Well, this is smashing.
Oh, yeah,
this is
like
smashing.
Pre,
oh,
like
who's this? Well, hello there.
We got you a date for today.
Date.
Yeah, this
Thank
is Vray. She doesn't talk much, but she's really sweet. She's going to be your date for today.
Wonderful to meet you, Vray.
So,
she wants to
Very
give you a drink.
Nice. All right. Yeah, what do I do to take it? That.
You just slurp.
Like a Roman emperor.
I'm slurping. Oh, that is some good tea. I love that tea.
You're right. Dude, he's a natural.
Oh, that's wonderful tea.
I think so, too.
Who would have thought? Dan Clancy's an RP-er.
You're a professional. Should invite him to Camilla's date night.
That is true. We have a date night next week if you want to come with another VTuber named Camila.
If I can make it, I will make it. Although, well, if I'm on date night, I think I'll have to be a different character.
You so
maybe
it's
not
a,
an old wizard.
That's fine.
It's an elimination date night. You can play any character you want, and they'll either eliminate you or tell you that you made it to the next round. And there's a talent show portion where you can show off your talents.
Can you actually say that
Croissant sounds like fun?
Yeah.
A wizard of your level must have many.
It is next Thursday at 9 p.m. CST.
Oh, well, that might just work. That might just work.
Hey, Dan Clancy for date night. Camilla would love that.
Oof. Okay.
Can you?
Are you hitting on him?
Just say courtesy at the other table.
No, I'm merely complimenting a fine beard of a fellow wizard. I...
All right. Clearly. Yeah, thank you.
Now, Mr. I almost said Mr. Clancy again. Dan, all right?
Whenever,
it just seems proper.
I know, whenever you say Mr. Clancy, I'm going to call you Mr. Rafflegator, not just Rafflegator. I'll call you Mr. Rafflegator.
But you, I told you the normie check name that you have to call me. If you really want to, if you, yeah, the worst thing you could call me is Gator. Like, that is the worst thing you can call me. Just go up and say, yo, Gator.
Some people call him Raffle.
What about Mr. Gator? Isn't Mr. Gator worse?
I'm okay with that, actually.
That's actually very common, and I think that one would work.
Thank you.
All right, well, whenever you call me Mr. Clancy, I will call you Mr. Gator.
Okay, fine. Acceptable, all right? But I'll call you Dan. Okay, so, Dan, before we go on our adventure... a lot of people wanted to do the TOS talk, so let's get the boring stuff out of the way, right? Let's get that TOS stuff out of the way.
All right.
And
for that, I won't use my my wizard voice.
Yeah.
If you insist, I'll de-wizard as well.
Yeah, you de-wizard as well. There's a lot of people that have a lot of questions, so I just want to go over some of that stuff, and then you're free from your obligations of TOS talk, and you could just... hang out with us, and we'll explore some worlds, and that'll be really fun, all right?
That sounds good to me.
Okay, so obviously the first thing that people want to know is what happened with the whole TOS change?
Before we do this, go ahead. Let me ask a question.
Okay.
And this really doesn't matter to me. Actually, it doesn't matter. Never mind. Don't worry. I was going to ask about the music in the background. When y'all do VR chat, y'all always have music in the background in many of the places?
It's world dependent, so what happens is the map creator can decide whether they want like a song in the background, and you can actually turn that music off if you want. I can teach you how to do that. But and you can turn it up as well.
So you can do it. It doesn't bother me because I won't keep the VOD, but it's copyrighted music, so one thing you always have to do is think about that, I assume?
Yes, that is something that we think about pretty often. A lot of mappers try to be very conscious about TOS stuff, because they know that a lot of people stream the games. Sometimes, realistically, like, you just get hit by that, and then we'll have to either delete the VODs, or the VODs will get muted or whatever. But yes, that is something that happens.
I will tell you the tricky thing, the thing you have to be careful of, I'll tell you now. The VODs you delete, and they're not there forever. The clips are the things that stay around forever.
Right, that makes sense.
And then with the music in the background, right now we don't have an issue. The labels are like at peace with us, but if ever we're not at peace, then you have a bunch of clips with background copyrighted music.
They'll come after us.
Risky thing.
I have a question about
right,
that, actually.
So, yeah. By the way, so Ken, it doesn't bother me, but you can turn it off so it doesn't go to stream or not?
You can, yeah. You want to answer
that? Yourself as well. Oh, fine. I didn't mean to cut you off. No, yeah, you can
fine.
Just turn the world music down, and it'll be super easy to separate it. Otherwise, you could separate it on the VOD, but that's a little bit more hassle, but you'd lose it for yourself as well.
Yeah.
I'm not that worried about it because I'll download the VOD and I won't keep the VOD long term, so it's fine.
Okay. Cool, because there are some there's some music stuff that we want to show you today, and I don't know what the TOS is about.
What will happen there? I know.
Yeah. I do want to. So one thing that you can do to make the game a little less clunky and have stuff all over your screen is you can press Control N. and then it'll turn off nameplates. You might have to press it twice. But if you press Control and N at the same time, it should disable the nameplates so that you don't have these ridiculous nameplates over everyone's name. Okay, and then if you
makes
okay,
it
perfect.
A little more immersive.
Yeah. Perfect. All right, you ready to have this talk? Ready to get this thing out of the way so we could go explore some VR chat?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Yes,
so
I'm ready.
Obviously, I think the thing that a lot of people are worried about is the TOS changes came through, and clearly people abused the hell out of it, right? Like, people went freaking crazy. There was penises everywhere, all sorts of inappropriate stuff all over the art section, and I'm assuming that's why you guys had to bring everything back, right?
Yeah, so initially we were doing it because there was a lot of artists that had expressed a desire to be able to use the human form as part of their artistic expression.
Right.
Now, it is fair to say, whenever something happens, in hindsight, you always said, yeah, I guess it's not that surprising that they did that. And of course, there are always people that say, well, I knew they would have done it. But they did very quickly overrun the art category, where basically the art category was now just dominated by all sorts of, nude content and nude anime. And then, of course, you have the whole AI issue, which we could have solved separately. But it basically then swamped the art category, right? And now the way it would be nice if our system worked, and often the real problem are thumbnails, because if someone's not interested in that content, but suddenly art is dominated by thumbnails of breasts and penises, that doesn't give that user a great experience.
That makes a lot of sense.
And so in a perfect world, A, we can blur thumbnails, and B, a user could say, I am not interested in seeing sexually themed content. So then they click the check mark, and suddenly they go to the art section, and anything labeled sexually themed, they don't see. So now they can have the experience they want. And in general, this would be good for the site. Okay, but we just don't have that yet. It's something we will build, but engineering takes time. And so we needed to roll back the change, not because we necessarily, find all the stuff is like somehow wrong or something like that. It's just our product doesn't work well to handle. And by the way, we already have this problem. If you look at the ASMR category, that's one thing that ASMR creators that do not create sexually themed content come to me and ask. They say, well, can't we have two ASMR categories? Because they make ASMR that is not sexually themed. But the ASMR category is often dominated by sexually themed ASMR content. And then that makes it difficult for those. So this problem already exists in a number of categories. And we felt like
that
problem to exist in the art category.
Right. Wouldn't it be possible for you guys to just let people tab it themselves? Like, instead of like having it like automatically blur things out, like, okay, if I want to draw nude stuff, like, can't I just select myself? Like, I'm going to be drawing adult stuff. So I click this tab that says I'm going to be drawing adult stuff. And then it just automatically blurs the Twitch icon for it. So like people are responsible for their own thing. And if they don't do that, then they get banned.
Well, no, because the icon we take from your live stream. It's not like you have a separate thumbnail. Your thumbnail is your live stream.
Right.
So there's no way that you can blur, because then it would be blurred for anyone watching your live stream.
Maybe.
Right? Doesn't that make sense?
I guess the way... Okay. So what you guys are going to...
Rob's asking. Yeah,
you're an English major.
He's asking if it would be beneficial in the future to add a feature that would allow users to blur their own thumbnail and just have a static blur that's not necessarily taken from their stream.
Yeah.
Right, or that you take their thumbnail, you take and then you blur it. Yes, in fact, I think there'd be two ways to do this. right?
We have too many people in here at the moment. I'll just invite people after this.
Basically, I think the
right way
to do it, since we already require that you, in the change, we were requiring you to label it as sexually themed. Okay?
Right.
So it's quite reasonable for us to have settings that would say, oh, for this user, you can choose, do you see sexually themed stuff? And you can say, no, I don't want to see it at all. Or you can say, yes, yeah, show it to me, but blur the thumbnail. In other words, it can be a user setting. Because some users don't want to see a blurred thumbnail because they, in fact, are interested in the content, right? And so the point is, as opposed to the streamer should classify it as sexually themed.
Right.
Okay, and we have that capability right now, okay?
Yeah,
and the streamers were in general classifying it appropriately. The thing we don't have is a viewer control where a viewer can then choose blur thumbnails or don't show me this. And that's something that takes time from an engineering perspective to build.
Okay, that makes a lot more sense. I guess the only so it is something that down the lines though you guys are potentially going to be looking at, right?
Yeah, it's not because we just need to be able to offer ways for users that are not interested in that content to not see that content, right? Because it's not like we think there's anything wrong with the content. It's just they're users that are not interested in that content.
Perfect.
I think that's totally fair, yeah.
Moving forward, a lot of people in VR chat specifically worry about attire. Because some people wonder whether or not virtual avatars follow the same rules as like IRL clothing, like in the IRL section and stuff like that. And there's this whole like the difficult thing about that is for one, if I'm hanging out with a bunch of people and someone has like, for example, underboob, like and they just happen to walk by the screen with their underboob, is that something where I should worry about getting in trouble? What are the rules for VR chat and attire and the TOS on that?
Now, that's a good question. And in fact, I am not an expert on every... In fact, I know I recently asked that question and I got an answer to that question. But that doesn't mean I remember the answer to that question. Okay. Guidelines... The guidelines of higher policy.
The CEO, kind of cool, dude. We've gone to dinner together. He's real down to earth, man. He is really down to earth, and he wants people to have more freedom and stuff. He's very straightforward too.
The way I think it should work, because part of this, what I don't want to do is mislead your community, because, you know, of course, I am not.
No, I get that. I get
an
that.
Expert on everything with the policies, right?
Because if you say something wrong and then I get banned, I'll be like, what the heck? Dan Clancy told me I could do this.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's always good to actually read the policy. Okay. And mm-hmm. So let's see. I'm looking at it right now. Trying to find it. Where is it? Higher safety, selfish violence, terrorism, adults. Sorry about this. Sexual.
He's good.
Okay, here we go. Okay, so. You cannot, you're not supposed to show a fictional nudity, okay? Now, let's separate out the issue of if it incidentally occurs and then you avoid it. That's a separate issue, right? There's one thing about you are encouraging it, you're focusing on it, you are engaging with it, all that. There's a separate question of, somebody comes on your screen. How do I, like, I want to stop this. I'm not meeting in, and how we should handle that. Okay. Let me just see. Okay.
Yeah. Because okay, what happens sometimes.
So nudity.
What happens sometimes is, like, for example, people are completely clothed, but like the avatars themselves, like, okay, I can accidentally clip through someone, right? Because there's no like colliders on people. Like I can walk through your model, right? So sometimes you'll walk through someone's model and you can like see their nipples like through their shirt for like a split second. And if I see something like that, like, do I have to worry about whether I get banned or not? Like, that, you know, because you were talking about like accidental nudity.
Now, you guys would know better than me, but my sense is that, in fact, like, has anybody here been banned for something like that or got a strike for something like that?
Never have, but I've always, like, immediately, like, deleted the VOD. If I do, like, see, like, a nipple accidentally, but it's not actual, like, boobs, right? It's just, like, a nipple that I see through a avatar that, like, you can't even make it out as a boob. Like, is that something where I have to delete the VOD right away? Or is that something where it's like, eh, you know, it's not really that big of a deal?
Right. It's a good question, because I think, but this is where I want to be careful. In fact, for questions like this, I always go and I check with, in fact, it probably wouldn't be a bad idea if I said, okay, write the exact questions, and then I only check.
I mean,
Chet,
you got to ask the hard questions,
right?
Give
you a very definitive answer, because I think in general, if you're in a virtual world and somebody, and it's a brief moment and you are not focusing on it, and you then don't focus on it, you move away, that sort of thing, I don't think they strike you.
Okay.
But I can't say that with 100%, like, you know, certainty. But I'm pretty sure that is the way they do it.
Somebody asked.
That seems to follow our experiences.
Okay, so I'm not a furry, okay? But there are a lot of furries in the VR chat community, okay? And they have, like, so what are the rules on them? Like, if, like, someone doesn't have sexual parts, like, they don't have, you know, genitalia, and or they don't have breasts, but they're completely naked in, like, a furry avatar. Like, what do you think the rules would be on that? Or do you even know what the rules would be on that? That seems a bit...
I have no idea what the rules are. I have no idea
furries.
What the rules are. And now, you know, probably it's not a horrible idea. In fact, in hindsight, we should have done this, because they're very nuanced questions. Like, what about a furry that has no genitalia?
Yeah, that's right? Why VR chat is so hard.
And so, in fact, and by the way, so I assume by this, they also are neither male nor female.
They don't present as male or female, like they don't have like in this situation, yes,
right,
it's like
right,
a
right.
creature,
right. It basically would look like a Barbie doll, well, not a Barbie doll, because a Barbie doll has breasts, but a Ken doll, although Ken is clearly designed as a man, but Ken does not have genitalia. If you took the pants off of a Ken doll, it's just smooth. That's basically what they look like, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say so.
Okay, I suspect because the policies are around nudity and genitalia and showing of sexual, you know, parts like buttocks or breasts or genitalia, right? And of course, now there is with butts, that's an interesting question, right? But they do not have genitalia or breasts. So by definition, you can't be showing genitalia or breast.
Yeah, I mean, there's a furry right there. Right. There's one right there. Look at that thing.
Yeah, that's fair. Like,
look at that thing.
This is an animal. Another way to put that, okay, now as you describe a furry like that, right, doesn't have any problems.
But if it was more humanized, it might become a problem, right? Like, as it becomes more like human-like, it might actually become an issue, right?
Yeah. I could see, let's put it this way. I could see that
get
being
off the table.
One of those things that
we're
that,
eating.
Like, that's that like gets towards the line that like an operator won't fully like a look at it and say, huh, I don't know what, like, because there's so many of those, like, you know, edge cases. But, you know, so I think as it gets, like, completely presenting as a human, right, but they just happen to be naked, so it looks like a naked human but just with no genitalia, then I'm not sure there, because there you can say, okay, it's a human. You've just taken the genitalia off, right? Whereas in this case, the furry is not not a human, it's an animal, right?
Right.
It's some form of a creature, right? And yes. So, you know, creatures don't have clothes, like dogs don't wear clothes. You're not expected, right? So you wouldn't expect them, it's silly to have a furry to have to wear clothes.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay.
Right, that makes sense. Thanks.
Perfect. All right.
Oh, do you mind if I ask one?
Yeah, you can ask a question. Go ahead.
I wanted to ask on behalf of a couple friends of mine who are creators of avatars like these. They design them.
That's where I was going to go next.
Fabricate them. And, oh, great minds think alike. Basically, they were wondering if it'd be possible to still stream in the art category, even though the bodies they develop and these like designs for these outfits, it's not sexual inherently in nature, but oftentimes the sculpting of the body will focus like on a breast, for example, like the sculpting of the 3D model. And if that would be okay in the art category under the current TOS to create virtual avatars to represent themselves, even though it's not a sexual case and oftentimes not even a skin color, just like a purple texture. And if that would be okay to do.
Meaning what they're doing is they're sculpting a breast, and at this point they're sculpting the breast with no clothes, and then subsequently they'll put clothes on the breast.
Yeah. Exactly. The intention is to create an avatar. Mm-hmm.
Right. They're Korean. But by the way, I don't know how they sculpt and create avatars. So I was assuming that the way they, in other words, when they sculpt and create an avatar, do they make it like they create breasts with nipples and like they make it as it would look nude and then they put clothes on top of it?
That would be a way that could be done, yes. Although there'd be room for nuance in the sense that if nipples or let's say genitalia weren't allowed, then they could not do those parts on their stream. But the question they wanted to know on behalf of you was whether or not that would be something that's possible under the new terms of service if they could do that in a non-sexual presenting manner to sculpt the full body.
So let's be clear, in like what we did was in this case we rolled back to the old policy just for simplicity, because when you make a change to then change some back to something. Now, we didn't roll back everything. We just roll back to the change for fictionalized characters. We didn't like roll back halfway, because in general, that's really confusing, because you have a line, you're planning on changing the line, and then you change the line to something that's somewhere in the middle. So Rob, keep track of that one. I suspect, okay, that if they are not drawing a nipple, I'm not sure on that one. I think it's a good question, right? They're not drawing a nipple. They are drawing a breast and sculpting it.
I'll keep track of it, guys.
I'm not sure on that one. And I think, Rob, it's a good idea to keep track of these ones. I'm not sure, because then I can check with them and talk to them.
You want me to just, like, ping you about it on, like, Discord or something? Or, like...
Just note right now, but create a file somewhere. And
all right,
just
I'm
like
on it.
Create notes of the ones that I'm not able to answer. So that way you can send me that list. And then after the break.
Sure. Okay, that actually sounds like a really good idea. Anything you can't answer, No, that's awesome, actually. Okay. 3D
long. Okay, cool.
Okay. Awesome. So I guess we're good on that. And then we'll go more into that later for the people wondering about model stuff. Okay. A couple more questions.
And by the way, I'll say the challenge with all of this is, of course, we need to have a policy that applies in general. And the challenge that comes in is person X may not be doing it in a sexualized manner. But then as soon as we let person X do it in a non-sexualized manner, the question is, does person Y do it in a sexualized manner? It becomes, you know, just like, so that's always the
You give someone an inch, they'll always take a mile, you know?
The give an inch, take a mile philosophy.
I'm not inviting
Zolbert. They're just going to abuse whatever bounds are set.
Yes. Like, and that's what's happening now with the, I don't know if you've seen the meta on the sensor bars.
Oh, yeah, I've definitely seen that. A few friends of mine have done that as a result. I was actually super curious about your feelings on that and where exactly that falls within the current TOS as well.
Yeah, the Tectone stream.
So let's go to the in general. By the way, part of this is, you know, in a perfect world again. Our product works so that people who don't want to see this stuff don't need to see the stuff. We know the stuff there, so that way, when it's certainly for kids or other things, then you know, blur it out or handle it accordingly. But for adults and other things, and people that are consenting, you know, they can do it. And we have a line, just like we currently have on a tire and other things. So we have no interest in going over the line into what would be, you know, considered, you know, truly adult or pornographic content. Not what any of this is. And so, and of course, the attire policy is an example of that, right? Because we have one policy if you're near a pool or a hot tub, and a different policy that applies more generally, right? And you know, it's one of these things that it's now become, because of course people put blow up pools in their room, right? And so it's kind of funny now, crazy. Actually. In fact, I've been thinking about if we could like loosen the attire policy, should we, or is it just kind of funny because right now it is kind of funny that everyone has these hot tubs in their room. But it is the fact. The challenge that comes in is if our product can't handle the sexually themed content well, and it ends up going into all sorts of categories, then I think that creates a bad experience, because in fact, then it can start dominating multiple categories. Right now, for example, if you're actually looking for people at a hot tub or a beach or a pool, it's very hard on Twitch, because that category is almost completely dominated by sexually themed content. Okay. Now, in general, that's not a category that's like this category that's so popular that it's hurting users. I can't find people that are at a pool. Okay, so that's not a big deal. ASMR it is. Okay. But bars, it's, you know, they're sort of pushing the limit, right? If you will.
Right.
And like one of the challenges is some of them have gotten banned because they push the limit, but the bar moves around. And then for a brief period of time, they're in violation of the attire policy. Okay? And then they get banned. Okay, and it looks like they're no different than this other person. However, it was for a period of time. So, however, I appreciate the women that are doing it. That's one thing, of course, this happened just over break where a number of people aren't around. But it is something we're still trying to think about what's the right thing there. You know, because I will say one of the things we have to think about is we need to make sure that for all of our streamers, the site works for them earning their living. And you know, ads are an important part of revenue for many streamers, and if you know, advertisers get concerned because content dominates, then that can affect other streamers. And so we have to find the right balance here for all the streamers. So I know I didn't give a clear answer on the black bar in terms of how I feel, because I'm still trying to figure out what I think, you know, because the way they do the black bar, you think they're naked. Right, that's the impression you get. That's what your mind is telling you, although they may not be. But your mind is telling you that they are.
Mm-hmm.
It's like those bubbled. Like, have you ever seen that thing where like someone will get a picture and like bubble it so that it looks like it's naked, but it's not. It's the illusion. Okay.
Ooh, that's so interesting.
No, that is interesting to think about. All right. Moving on to something that has actually plagued our community, and it's something that I think is very important, is the AI chat system. This is something that we've had huge issues with.
Hold on one second. Before we go on to there,
okay,
I do want to take one moment to say one thing in general about this whole space, right? Because it's certainly the case that it used to be area in terms of adult content. It was actually a area where women would get abused, they would get injured, they would be exploited, and many other things, right? And I think one of the things to realize now when you look at something, what's happening on Twitch and the women that are creating sexually themed content, you know, They're earning a living. They are not hurting anybody, and the people that are watching are choosing to watch. And so I think sometimes people use derogatory words towards them. They mischaracterize them. They denigrate them and act like what they're doing is somehow wrong or inappropriate or anything else. And I you know, strongly disagree with that, because I do think it's very important to acknowledge that they are not hurting anyone. They're adults. The people that may choose to watch them are adults. And it's very different than what happens if you want to talk about pornography or other things. It is not. It is sexually themed. So this is just on behalf of them, because I think they do get a lot of abuse on our site. That is not merited.
No, I completely agree with that. I don't think there's anyone here that would disagree with that. Yeah, that is definitely like the case, and we all agree with that so hard. And you know, if you want to be angry at anyone over that stuff, like, be angry over the people that consume the content, if anything. Like, people obviously enjoy the content, so they're gonna like if there's clearly like a market for it. So, you know, why be pissed off at them? Yeah, they're just trying to make a living.
The other thing I'm going to say, because I think a lot of people point out the issue of 13 plus kids. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I have a daughter who's 25, a son who's 21.
I don't have a problem with porn. I don't think there's anything wrong with porn.
There is now a significant amount of evidence that shows that the incidence of anxiety, depression, challenges with kind of self-identity and other things, you see there are all sorts of graphs that show this marked decline in this starting around 2010 with the advent of mobile phones, okay? And the evidence is pretty compelling that spending 5 hours on social media when you're 10, 11, 12, 13 is not healthy for you. That has nothing to do with nudity. That has to do with, you know, you can have someone that's fully clothed but an idealized image that then, and that you're not interacting and socializing. And so sometimes we act like, oh, this problem with the internet is someone might see someone naked. The problem with the internet is what happens with 13-year-olds and their friends. What happens with 13-year-olds and, you know, the content that you will see scrolling on Instagram or scrolling on TikTok quite commonly. And there is a lot of data to show that. And so I can tell you, I, for one, you know, I think it's a great idea to have 13-year-olds roaming around unfettered on the internet, right, as a parent, because there's just a lot of stuff on the internet, and Twitch is the least of your problems. So I do agree that it's something to be considered, but there's a lot of challenges with, in general, social media and the internet as you're starting talking about kids.
No, agreed. 100%
Would you say the
agreed.
Onus?
Go ahead.
Like, falls on the parents to police that for their children's content. Twitch provides a safeguard system to work in, and then it would be up to the parents to make sure that their children are following the content tags that are then provided
on the parents, in my opinion,
by your site. Yeah, I mean, I would assume that'd be a fair thing to expect.
Yes. Yes.
Because if you don't monitor what your kids do, they end up like me.
The stuff they're doing by posting on, you know, social media all the time, and then looking at how many likes their posts get or what their friends do and all that, that actually is like much more dangerous and much more challenging for children these days because of the you know, the dopamine of doing that. So I think there are a lot of issues mm-hmm. there to look at. Yeah. All right, let's go to your next one.
Okay, and remember, guys, if you do not monitor your children, they do end up like the people in this lobby, okay? So please keep an eye on your kids, or they will end up like us. Okay, so this is a very important one. We've had a lot of issues with the chat AI moderating system. Basically, there's no way for an AI to understand context, right? And because of this, a lot of people in our community will make like a joke with the streamer that doesn't offend the streamer, but you know, it out of context can look really bad and have gotten indefinite bans, 2-week bans, like any amount of duration of bans. And I feel like the system is a little bit flawed, and I think a lot of other people find it very flawed. And we were wondering if there's any way to improve the system by maybe letting like the streamer have more of a say in it, like let the streamer decide whether or not that was an appropriate thing, and that and like action should be taken, similar to like how video games do it, where like in League of Legends, like there's the report system and like the players report, and then it lets you know like, hey, you know, this person got banned, like congratulations on reporting them and whatever, like where if it's actually offensive, like the streamer has a bigger part in that person being banned, instead of like some AI and no context being used, and then next thing you know, you get an indefinite ban over a joke with your friend, you know.
Yeah. So first of all, for clarity, we don't have AI banning anyone. People think it's AI doing it. It is not AI doing it. So we do use AI for auto mod, which has nothing to do with bans. Okay. In other words, and your moderators see, you know, when auto mod makes suggestions, and you can see where it sometimes does a good job and sometimes misinterprets, and your moderator then can make a decision about what should go through. The mistakes that you see are being made by human beings.
Okay, so it's human error.
It's human error. And that doesn't mean the problem does. Interestingly, AI might do better than them. Because we think that humans are great at figuring out context and all these other things. Actually, sometimes humans are quite bad at detecting when something is a joke. And that, in fact, then they make mistakes. That's like, oh, this is a joke. It shouldn't be. I mean, the quintessential, I'll use an example that is using AI, okay, where, but not us using AI. There is a stream of an AI interview of, I forget who the character was, but it was AI generated, somebody, and this was in France, and they asked them, named the five worst named city in France. And the person in chat who asked the AI bot this question knew that there was a city in France that had a name that was anti-Semitic.
Okay.
So okay. The AI bot said the name of the city, and it is an anti-Semitic phrase, and I won't repeat what the name of the city is. Okay, and it was in French. And the AI channel ended up getting banned for this. Now, it appealed, and we cleared it. But it was an example where a human did not realize, oh, this person wasn't saying this anti-Semitic comment, right? It was somebody asking a question who was stating the name of a city, okay? So I think you raise an important point, you know, and the interesting thing is for the longest time, We only evaluate somebody for something they said in chat if somebody reports them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the issue is people...
We don't have anybody scanning chat.
People are spam reporting, right? Because anytime something is abusable, someone will abuse it, obviously, right?
Yeah, absolutely. But I wanted to be clear. I didn't want anyone here to have the idea that we had AI scanning chat and then detecting things that we think are inappropriate, and then us filing a report on it. Right? The reports are made by humans. I think this is one of the challenges that we need to, you know, keep looking at, because I do agree with you. Sometimes it's like, wait, no, that was clearly a joke. It was taken out of context. It was, using a term that was not derogatory in the use of that term. Now, how to do that at scale is tricky. But and the one thing you said that I think I'm a little torn on, that on this question of whether or not the streamer found it offensive, it gets a little tricky here, because sometimes certain streamers might find very egregious things that anyone listening would think is inappropriate. But the streamer might say, no, I'm okay with it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That's fine if they say that, right? That doesn't mean everyone else was okay with hearing it. So now I'm going in an extreme example, right? So if someone was freely using the N-word, right, a streamer might say, no, I'm not offended by that. But that doesn't mean other people in chat aren't offended by that.
Right. And right? I think something like that is like pretty obvious, right? Like the F word, N word, stuff like that. Like that should be like an auto ban. But if someone says something like, for example, like I've seen someone get banned for saying men are scum, right? Like I feel like something like that, you know, like that's like so, you know, debatable, right?
I completely agree that I think sometimes, and I think one thing we have to always look at is see when maybe in an effort to provide the safe environment, somebody says something that, while maybe a little offensive, doesn't go over a line, right? And it's always tricky to find the right line. Okay. And so I think you raise some examples, but it's not AI. In fact, actually, in some ways, again, I think AI might be able to do better. And I think we need, and I will say, you know, we do have an appeal process. Of course, you don't like to get banned and then have to go through the appeal process. I mean, it used to be that it took a while for appeals to be followed up on, and now we've gotten the queue down, so we're actually quite timely in handling appeals, whereas in the past we were not timely in doing it.
So,
you know, I think this is something we have to continually work on.
Yeah, the appeal process itself is a little bit flawed because, like I said, we had a friend who, like, okay, something happened on stream and there was like a context of like a dude doing something rude and then walking away, and then someone in chat typing like men are scum, for example, right? And then they got banned from Twitch, and then they appealed and the appeal got declined, and it's like, I can't imagine that being something that's like worth getting like declined over, right? Like something, you know, like that. And there are other scenarios where people will maybe make like a mildly inappropriate joke, but not something that you could literally say on Twitch, right? Like you could say on stream and you would never get banned for it, but people would get banned for it from Twitch chat. And that just, to me, that seems a little bit ridiculous that like the Twitch chat is more strict than literally streaming in front of thousands of people and saying things. Because there are things that I could say right now, but if I was on a non-partnered account and I typed it, I would get banned for it. Which I think that part is kind of weird.
I don't disagree, and especially if you know anyone that's dealt with that. Part of this is in getting it right, we need to continually refine and find areas where the team that makes the decision, because you have to do this all in a scalable way with hundreds of thousands of reports, and like it, the complexity of doing this is quite large. So I will say this, to the extent you like know somebody that, you know, experiences something like that, feel free to reach out to me, because some of this isn't just dealing with the one issue.
Right.
But then to find, well, why didn't the appeal overturn this, right?
In maybe general, maybe they've done other things in the past.
The decision. Yeah.
Okay. All right, cool. Okay. Yeah, that's been a big thing that we have been dealing with here. Because, I mean, our community, we're all super cool with each other, and we like to banter with each other. And sometimes we banter with each other in chat, and it's not something that would, like, offend our viewers or offend each other. But out of context, like, if you didn't know any of us, you'd be like, holy crap, like, this person's really offending this, like, other person. Like, my chat calls me fat all the time, and they'll make fat jokes towards me all the time, and I'm not offended by it, but, like, if someone came in, they'd be like, holy crap, like, how could they talk to this guy like that? Like, that just seems so ridiculous, you know what I mean? So it's like context for everything.
Yep, agree with that.
In such a case, all of E-Rob's chat would be banned. I mean, they just tear the poor guy apart.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. And I'm sure a lot of people from E-Rob's chat have gotten banned. Next question then. So I read that with the Twitch TOS, the art part is the part that got overturned, but the part with like pole dancing, grinding, stuff like that is still okay. And I was wondering if I could get your input on what exactly is okay in that sense. Like, for example, if someone was like relatively well clothed and they started like lap dancing, for example, is that something that Twitch would allow now under these new rules?
So I and like And it makes sense that you'll go to, I want to get to like the edge cases. And the problem is I want to be, it's always tricky on the edge cases. So let me, I'm going to stay away from the edge case and then I can go check on the edge case. So let's take, for example, pole dancing.
Right.
Right. Pole dancing now has become something that is not necessarily sexualized. Right. Although some people also do it in a sexualized manner, but it's not worse than what happens in, you know, in already in hot tub streams. Right. So right. To consider that inappropriate, it's like, well, wait, why is that worse than what's happening in hot tub streams? Market is sexually themed. Right. The other thing, there was another, besides the lap dance, you used another example.
We asked him about the attire policy.
Pole dancing. And
he wasn't too sure. He didn't give us a concrete answer about that.
I forget the example you used, but
there was twerking,
one of the other
pole
changes.
Dancing.
Oh,
and,
oh, twerking. Yeah, let's go
and,
twerking.
And lap dancing. What,
yeah, let's go with twerking. Twerking now is something that happens in dancing all the time. You go to a nightclub, you're going to see people twerking, right?
Right.
And so to ban
yeah, I'll
someone
ask them about grinding
for twerking,
too. Don't worry.
You know, if you're IRL streaming in a nightclub, then you're going to be in trouble, and you can have someone twerking at the Super Bowl. Oh, halftime. Right. And so it's probably the case that we need to make sure someone doesn't get banned at the Super Bowl halftime. Right. Now you went to the whole issue of a lap dance. Okay. And I think that's going in. Of course, there's always a boundary. But going to an erotic dance with a partner. Right. Now, because then you can, it's easily to start to get into simulated sexual activity.
Right.
Right? Because that's a big part of erotic dancing, especially a lap dance. And it is the fact that simulated sexual activity, right, is banned. And so in general, I'd say, you know, and the problem is always when you start getting
for the fiber.
Your line, that, you know, what is a healthy erotic dance? Or let's take a strip.
Looks like Clancy's not getting a lap dance tonight.
Right, that in fact, women that are stripping as part of the performance, and then you start throwing in the hot tubs, and in general, I think that's probably pushing the limit.
Thank you for
I don't.
That.
I'm not going to the specific wording, but I don't think. Let me go to the new policy in terms of sexual content. Let me just look at that. That would be helpful.
Because another thing is like grinding is allowed too now, so like that act of grinding, but like let's say for example there's not like a body underneath the person, but the person's like making like a grinding motion with their body, right? Like how would that fall
right,
under? Because
that, yeah.
It looks sexual, but there's no, it's one person, right? It's just like one person moving.
Right. That does not seem like I'm looking at the examples now, right?
Which would raise the question, like, if I'm a first-person angle and you don't see, like, my crotch area and the person's just dancing, we're not really stimulating, there's, like, simulating sex, right?
I'm just reading through it to see if I missed something.
No worries. That's really interesting.
Well,
so would it be possible to give, then, like, an erotic lap dance to your stream camera in the sense that it's you performing by yourself? For your stream, but there's no one receiving the dance. Is it the act of receiving it that makes it erotic with the partner, or
like,
if it's
yeah,
by yourself,
right.
Is it more of an athletic endeavor?
Or if you like see them grinding on someone else, so you visually actually like, you know, see something that almost looks like sex with clothes on, right?
Right. I mean, that's the thing. The problem that gets in here is even if there is not another person there. You still can have simulated sexual activity without a person there.
Darn.
Mm.
Right?
That would make sense,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and the problem is, as you start moving to the line, here, my general feeling on this is, you know, ultimately there are humans reporting and humans analyzing this, right? And so the more you try to just get right to the line, okay, the more people always say, oh, you're inconsistent. That's because if there's a line, it's weird because I'm using my hands as if you can see me, and of course people on my screen can see me, but you can't. If there's a line,
you should get VR for next time.
As you get really, really close to the line, okay, then you get like 5 people to look at it and say which side of the line it is, and of course you have 10 people to do it, and 5 will people say it's on this side of the line, 5 will say it's on that side of the line, right? And so it looks like we're inconsistent, and it's because they are straddling the line. And they're going right up to what is allowed. And it would be, in a perfect world, everything can be completely objective so that a algorithm can just, like, do it. But there is no such, when you're dealing with human beings, there is no such perfect objective criteria, right? So the challenge as you start getting into, a lap dance, right, is you start getting into explicit, simulated, fictional, or implied sex or masturbation, okay, then you can start saying, no, that, you know, it's a chair, but it sure looks like you're having sex with the chair, you know? And
right.
Mm-hmm. So, and then will a person look at that and say, yeah, they're kind of like, that's what they're doing, right? So, whereas twerking is now, nobody thinks, like, twerking has now become...
What if there's no object?
Part of dancing.
What if they're just floating?
Right?
I don't know if this is a silly question, but what if there's like no object there? What if they're literally just in the air? Like, because you could just put your VR chat avatar in the air.
I want to be careful. Right. I want to be careful about going too far there. And like, it doesn't work for me to try and explain stuff that is an inch from below.
Well, because he's saying it looks like you're fucking the chair, right? So what if you're
not
having sex with the chair?
Then someone can say, wait, Dan said this. And... like,
yeah,
I can
we don't want that to happen.
Clearly away from the line. We can talk about stuff that is clearly away from the line. Twerking, like we've been very clear, that is not a problem.
Okay.
Doing a pole dance, that is not a problem. Okay. As we start saying, and my general recommendation is,
I understand.
At some level, I don't know. Like, I know people will always try to get right up to the line.
I'm just checking if he knows.
My question is why.
Why do
it's
people
almost
want...
like they're doing it to try and they're doing it to push the line, right? You know, in other words, they're just by definition what they're trying to do is get to close to the line without going over the line.
Well, I think a lot of people, right? It's as the adage goes, right? Sex sells, right? Sex sells. So the reason they're trying to find that line is because they're trying to get away with as much as they can. To you know, make it as close as they can to, like, you know, that kind of content. I don't think it really is anything about like, ooh, I'm gonna see how far I could go today. For me, it's more or less
I understand.
Yeah, I just want to like create like an entertaining thing, and we have like incredible dancers in this community, and it sucks that I have to like swap over to Kick and like, you know, bring my viewers over to Kick, because I've been partnered on this platform for 10 years. I am a Twitch loyal boy.
Right.
Dude, I'm one of like the first like 60 people partnered on this platform. I don't want to go to a different platform, right? But you know, if I want, like, some people want to see like, you know, these talented lap dancers move around and stuff. And if I could just like, you know, mark my stream as not safe for work and be like, yo, we're just gonna do it right here. But you know, maybe I can't make ad revenue during this next hour or something like that. Like, that would make my life so much easier, right? But instead, you know, I have to swap over to Kick, and like, I hate having to do that, right? I want to be a Twitch boy for life.
Go ahead and put that on your list in terms of, and by the way, I do think there's a distinction. Put that on your list of questions in terms of lap dancing without another person there. So put that on your list.
Okay, I'll put that on my list. Perfect. Okay. Chat, are there any questions that we didn't go over that you guys want to know about? We can't sit here all day and talk about TOS because I'm sure Dan's got things to do, and I do want to show him a little bit of VR chat as well. But if there are very important things that I missed, let me know. I'm not going to ask about that. I'm definitely not going to ask about that. I mean, I could ask him his favorite ice cream flavor, but I don't think that's going to... I don't think that has anything to do with anything. How big is what?
Well, you can ask that question. You can ask that question while we're wandering around.
Yeah, that's true. We could do that.
Yeah.
We already talked about how the TOS equates to virtual avatars. You're echoing, by the way. Who's echoing?
Someone's echoing. You got a little bit of an echo.
Oh, we do have a VRChat developer here, by the way. That person, Tupper, there is one of the head devs for the game. Tupper, do you have anything cool you want to show us today? Because, like anything that you think Dad would want to see? We were going to show him, he's a DJ, so we were going to show him some, like, audio visualizer worlds.
I'm not a DJ, to be clear, I'm not a DJ, interestingly. I'm a music streamer. My initials are DJ, but I still like
that makes sense. So you're not even, I thought you were a DJ this whole time. I was like, DJ Clancy in the mix.
I play the piano and sing on my chat.
He's going to play a little show for us today.
Yeah, we'll do it. That
sounds wonderful.
Okay. Well,
I'm so down. That sounds super fun.
But it's still fun to see. DJ rooms are fun. So.
Yeah, I wish we could take you to an actual club. I wish one day just off stream. Well, because they usually have like 80 people in them. And it's super hard to moderate. It's something that people usually do off stream because people can have all sorts of avatars there, right? You're in the jungle, right? Like,
Yeah.
So, that's more like an off stream thing. I'd have to show you if you ever are interested in that. But we do have what they're called particle dancers, and they wanted to show you some stuff. So basically, what they do is they implement like a whole world into their VRChat avatar, and they dance with full body. While the world works with them. Would you like to see something like that?
Let's go see it.
Okay. Mr. Panda, your homie wants to come show stuff too, right? You guys can each do a song if you want. Oh, hold on. And then do you guys need to go to a different world or do you want to do it here?
I think go to all the different worlds so that it doesn't lag. And
you could drop a portal. I taught Dan how portals work. Right. So you could drop a portal and he'll be able to go through it.
All right. Nice. Guy, where do you want to go? You want to go to the animation test world?
Let's do it.
Okay, cool.
All right.
The dancer community in this game is like ridiculous. There's a lot of like clubs and dances and all sorts of really cool things. What is that accent? He's Korean. You're Korean, right, Mr. Panda?
No. I'm Singaporean. I'm Vietnamese, but living in Singapore right now. Ooh,
really? Why did I think you were Korean? Who's Korean?
I couldn't say Great Lunar Roma, maybe? I don't know. Lindsay's Korean.
That's not racist, chat. It's just ignorant. It's ignorant. Hi, Maury.
Maybe I break something out, too. Who knows?
Okay, we're just waiting for this man to drop a portal. Alright. Dan, I just need you to go through this portal now.
Oh, God.
He's got it, dude. Alright, perfect.
We got a portal.
He's got a big sword. He doesn't know how to use the shift key to run. Okay, the worst thing that could happen right now is he spawns inside of someone and sees their tits. That would be the worst thing that could happen right now. I'm really praying that doesn't happen. All right, guys, clear out a spawn so Dan doesn't load inside of you guys.
That'd be sad.
Please. But
like, pretty much all of you, all of your avatars been made by an artist?
Yeah, most of them are custom original characters. A lot of people work on them themselves or commission people to do it.
Yeah, some of the people in there, like Almond, she created her avatar. Not the deer, but the one next to it.
Right. I mean, there may be some that do, but it's because they're artists themselves.
Cause, you know.
And so basically, all the avatars I see here are ones that some artist, either because you're an artist,
just
or you
your
an artist create you the avatar, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Rob, yours kind of like you.
No.
This is a one-to-one scale with me in real life, yes. One-to-one scale.
You want me to go first? Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
All the muscles are yours, right?
Yeah, I'm very muscular. I do have a female one, but I was too embarrassed to use it in front of you.
How much does it cost to... Right, in other words, I will note this, like... You know, you're like unusual in a male one versus female.
Well, so female avatars sell a lot better, you know? That's why most VTubers are female, too.
Yeah. Okay. Now, how much does it cost to get someone to make you a fun avatar?
So, a lot of people, what they'll do, so there's one of two ways. If you commission a from scratch one, meaning like everything is made from scratch, like feet, feet to head, everything, that can cost anywhere, depending on the artist, like $1,500 to like even like $3,000. It's not super cheap.
Yep.
But what a lot of people will do is they'll learn how to use like Blender, or they'll learn how to use like Unity, and they will buy like an avatar for like 30, 40, 50 bucks, and then they'll just edit it to fit like their style, right? So that they might like change the hair, change the eyes, and that's probably the most common thing, is people will just learn how to do things themselves and just edit it to be how they want it.
Yep. All right. Let's see the fun stuff. Right.
Okay. Look at this man right here. He's going to lead the way for now.
All right, so actually, I want my friend to perform first. I think you've seen Sky perform once before, Rob.
Yes, but amazing, maybe don't have an avatar battle with pasties and like your shirt off, you know, with the CEO of Twitch around, you know. I think that'd be like.
I wish I could change it. I wish I could.
That's pretty borderline.
Yeah, it's borderline. Am I good, Dan?
Dan, is this gonna get us in trouble?
Roughly, you tell me, Rob. You tell me, Rob. You know better than me.
All right, stay far away from us, okay? Well, they're using particles.
Don't worry. I'll be far away. No, don't worry.
You did the raffle card, by the way. You failed the normie check.
I know. No. Yeah, I did not finish it, though. I corrected myself.
If you can utilize your avatar hider, because this is going to get really heavy. Like, I'm going to have to hide everybody in this lobby right now, or else I'm going to die.
If you are in
VR, turn up your avatar sound.
Hide everything, or there's a good likelihood you could crash out from this.
Yes.
Dan's probably got like a good PC, right?
Yeah, I do have a decent thing.
No.
Okay.
Yeah. If you have a good PC, then you'll be good. Hold on, I'm just.
Make sure you show Sky and turn up her avatar sound, so it's avatar sound performance.
Yes, please turn on your avatar sound. Set that.
I'm gonna get banned over a stream with fucking Dan Clancy in here because this dude decided to come in here with pasties.
Wait, what do I need to do?
If you go to your audio thingy, your audio menu, you can turn up avatar.
I think he has his avatars all the way up, but we can make sure.
Audio that comes from the avatar.
Okay, press escape and then click the little sound on the bottom.
No, avatars are at 30%. They're at 30% right now. Put them on.
You want it at 100?
Oh, nice.
At least 70.
Okay, at least 70.
You're the new DJ.
All right, that's it, 90.
Whatever you feel like you need to do.
Okay.
I'll go 100.
All right, let's make sure everyone loads in the AV first.
Okay, alrighty. So, if everybody has me loaded, then I can go ahead and place my world constraint. If you can see this above me, just kind of spinning around, then you are good to go. You have me fully shown.
I see it.
Yeah, there's a giant thing over your head.
Good. This guy's about to perform.
Yeah, yep. Yeah, there's a big giant thing. All right, I'm going to hit play.
Dan has all his safety settings off.
There's going to be a little warning card if you have epilepsy.
But now the thing isn't over your head anymore.
Yeah, epilepsy warning.
There it is. Now I see it. I see it.
Would you like to perform to you? I'll give up my spot for you. Because I want to show them something cool.
この先に何があるんだろう?
Okay, this is pretty cool so far, actually. It, like, changed the whole thing to water.
いつからか考えなくなった。考え方。
They're not in the best.
それすら忘れてしまったのかも。変わらない。自分だけの世界が、毎日が、続いていく。
We got the gift bottom left. What gift? There's nothing there.
でも、寂しくはない。どうってことないんだ。
He's like looking way in the air. Wait, what is he looking at? Oh. Someone in his chat said enable dark mode. He said he doesn't care about dark mode because he could just or he doesn't I'm sorry, he doesn't care about DMCA because he's gonna delete the VOD. He did say DMCA is cool with us right now, but he's gonna like fucking he's actually on fire. Nuke the VOD afterwards. Is this song like super DMCA? Giga DMCA? Of course, fucking. They give me the person with the fucking. Dude, Panda's like, my friend's gonna dance. I get the fucking person with that comes in with the pasty TOS avatar playing the most DMCA song ever. Classic? The classic, dude. Never met this person. Well, no, they were on my friends list already. But I also trust Panda. He's a nice guy. I literally told him. If you get banned, Dan gets banned too. Listen, what better way to get clout than by getting banned with the CEO of Twitch, you know? This is a joke. VR chatters, please don't use this against me. What are Robertson's super chill with streamers? I've heard that, but I don't know. Is there any dancing in this? Or is this just like all visual? He streams VR chat sometimes? That's right, he does do that. See Dan's character? I can't see any other characters. It disables them all. But Dan is Gandalf. What is even happening to this? I don't know. I've never seen this performance. Too repetitive for you? No, I agree with you. I'm trying to think what else I could show Dan that could be really fun right now. I don't want to sit here and look at fucking visual effects for like 30 minutes. This is literally a music video. Ask him if he lit one up. I'm not showing him the plus one jump world. We're not going to H Club either. Organism's cool. A horror map? Yeah, we're gonna go to H Party, dude. We're gonna get Dan Clancy on the third fucking floor. Show him eye tracking. But do you think he even cares about that kind of stuff? Muse Stacker. Audio Orb is really cool. Cord is cool. I am not inviting Kitty Nikki here. Holy fuck. Why does everyone want to join up me now? I'll invite Sam. I trust Sam. Bro, is this like the extended version of the song? Take Dan to DJ night. Please take him. 1 hour version. Play Prison Escape.
Arigato.
Okay, cool. So yeah, that's particle dancing. Like, yeah. So basically, they put in like the animations themselves, and they like edit all of that in themselves, and then they do dancing while the where are you, by the way? Are you still here? I don't know where you are. Where is Dan? Oh, there he's all the way back
I'll
here.
Come over by you, Rob.
Yeah. I think they want to do one. Do you want to see one more? I think they want to do one more dance performance for you, and
yeah,
then we'll move
wonderful.
On to the next thing.
That,
okay,
that
cool.
Sounds good. Was I in the wrong spot?
Can you tell him where's the best place for him to stand for yours? We'll do one more. We'll do one
just
more particle dance. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. I'll do.
Do you see this dude right here? Yeah. Just stand right here, and you'll get the best spot.
Hi. Alright, please everyone load me in. This is also Avatar Sound. This is an old performance, but I hope you'll enjoy it.
Hi, Jufa. How are you, Jufa?
I'm happy I'm next to Mr. Womus.
Have me loaded.
Thanks, Jufa.
Can you see me, Mr. Dang? The full Avi?
Yeah, I can see you.
Yeah. Alright. So everyone can see me, everything good to go, and I'll start.
Looking good, man.
All you do is just stay right there, just stay right there, and you will see the performance.
You're perfect, Dan, right there. So this guy only has one base station tracking his movement, by the way. So when he turns around, sometimes his movement gets a little wonky, but basically, Dan, people in VRChat can like set up feet, and like chest and all sorts of like trackers so that it tracks their full body. Unfortunately, he only has one base station that actually tracks this stuff. So if he turns around, he literally loses tracking. So he has to be very strategic with how he does everything.
Precarious performer.
So this dance is called it's called Hope. It's a song called Hope. It's about
Dan's
Hope.
Got 800 viewers though. He's doing pretty
and
good on viewership
fail,
for this. That's a lot more than he gets on a lot of this stuff.
So never give up on your dream and have hope and fight in your inner demons. And without further ado, I'll just start my performance. So once again, Avatar Sound up to 100, and I shall start.
I always start with feet. Well, feet are very important.
Yeah, I'm on my way, I'm coming. Don't lose faith in me. I know you've been waiting.
Nah, the other dance was really good too. It's just it felt more like a music video. I love to see like the actual like dancer up close.
30 years you've been dragging your feet, telling me I'm the reason we're stagnant. 30 years you've been claiming your honesty and promising progress. Well, where is it at? I don't want you to feel like a failure. I know this hurts, but I gave you your chance to deliver.
Also, DMC, no, we've already covered that. He's deleting the VOD.
Don't get me wrong. It's time to give the people something different. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce my
it's Imagine Dragons. I think this is like Imagine Dragons, but different.
Hope.
I only listen to metal, dog. What do I know, man?
Definition of success. Listening to what your heart
says. NF.
You know is.
I don't know who NF is.
What's my definition of success? Creating something no one else is.
Imagine Dragons of Rap. That makes sense. I see it. My spooky chip turns up hard to this.
All
right, what should we bring them to next?
Or change who they are just to try and gain some credibility so they can feel accepted by a stranger. It's a person that can take the failures in their life and turn them into motivation.
Public black cat.
In yourself when no one else does. It's amazing what a little bit of faith.
The arcade world sounds cool.
If you don't even believe in you, why would you think or expect anybody else to surround you to? I done did things that I regret. I done said things I can't take back. Was a lost soul at a crossroad who had no hope, but I changed that. I spent years of my life.
life, holding on to things I never should have kept, full of hatred. Years of my life
carrying a lot of baggage. I think arcade is a really good choice. Years
of my life wishing I was someone different, looking for some validation. Years of my life trying to fill a void, pretending I was in. They get it. Necessary evil, difficult to go through, yes, but beneficial. Some would say having a mental breakdown is a negative thing, which on one hand I agree, but on the other hand, it was the push I needed to get help and start the healing process. See, if I'd never hit rock bottom, would I be the person that I am today? I don't believe so. I'm a prime example of what happens when you choose to not accept defeat and face your demons.
Give him a lap dance. He said no lap dances. Get the
opportunity to be the greatest version of yourself. Sometimes you gotta be someone you're not to hear the voice of reason. Having kids will make you really take a step back and look in the mirror. At least for me, that's what it did. I wake up every day and pick my son up, hold him in my arms and let him know he's loved. Love. Standing by the window questioning if that is ever going to show up. Isn't something he's gonna have to worry about. Don't get it twisted, that was in a shot. Mama, I forgive you, I just don't want him to grow up thinking that he'll never be enough. 30 years of running, 30 years of searching, 30 years of hurting, 30 years of pain, 30 years of fearful, 30 years of anger, 30 years of empty, 30 years of shame, 30 years of broken, 30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hey, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later.
Do a cuddle puddle? That's a really good idea. Yeah, let's just start a cuddle puddle. A VR chat cuddle puddle. 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of torment, 30 years of 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never revolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same. You don't have the heart. You don't have the strength. You don't have the will. You guys hate this song, dude. You'll never be safe. Might as well give up. Not running away. You don't have the guts. You're the one afraid. You guys really hate this song. I don't know anything about NF. I only listen to metal. Yeah, good shit, Panda. Good shit.
God, that was so fucking cool.
Woo! God damn. Cool.
Sorry, Jufa.
Yeah, hell yeah, bro.
All right.
So cool.
Fucking shoulder checker, bro.
Dan.
So I have a. Can I ask a question about
sure,
that?
Sure, of course you can.
So, because obviously he was dancing in this room now, but did he? Was he able to improvise his dance, or did he have to, since the visuals, how much was the visuals responding to his dance and his ability to improvise in the dance, or were the visuals canned and therefore his dancing was scripted?
So I think he's probably changing his audio right now, but correct me if I'm wrong. Oh, okay, go ahead. Yeah. Do you want to tell him, like, how you do everything?
So, to make a performance like this, first, you got to bring the AV to Unity and plan out the full performance first.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say, like, not the dance specifically, just the particles. Then the dance, you can normally just improvise that a little bit. As long as you know where the drop is and how to make an impact and make your dance feel better, you know, you can improvise the dance and make it visually nice. And also,
some of it was synchronized. So, for example, when you had your body down below and it was responding, like, in other words, so
that is on me.
He is doing that.
That is on the Avi.
He pushes a button that clones his avatar, and as he pushes it, he can adjust where the clone is. The clone will match his movements, but turning on the clone, that's actually, it's kind of hard. While he's dancing, he has to push the buttons on his controller to get to the menu to turn that on, and then he has to reposition the clone like mid-dance. That's actually what makes that really impressive. Is the fact that he's going through a menu and turning this stuff on and moving it around in the middle of the dance.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the really, that's the hard part.
It's basically multitasking.
Now, one of the things I know I need to do is, and unfortunately my bandwidth is slow, hopefully I'll get it down, I want to be able to download the whole VOD before any of the audio tracks get muted, so hopefully I'll be able to download it. Actually, if I go and unpublish it, I don't think they will run... let me see if I can unpublish them. I think I may be able to.
Hi, Sam. Now that pole dancing is allowed, Sam, you could go ham. There are people that do pole dancing in VR as well who could literally, like, spin around and do crazy things. Do you have your pole up right now?
It's pretty crazy.
Can you do any non-sexual pole dancing? See, like, this person right here has a pole in their room, and they could do. Can you show Dan really quick what that looks like in VR when you do that? Okay, they'll show really quick. They're just setting up their controllers so that like they don't mess themselves up. Do you want me to do a song? Can you do it without being super lewd? Okay, yeah. Do you want to see them?
Pole dancing is okay.
Do you want to see them do a pole dance in VR? It looks crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead, Sam. Hit it.
Woo! Yeah.
Okay.
On.
Do you need a second to set up? All right, perfect.
It's the good part about VR. All the poles are portable.
We're deleting VODs today, so music, I don't think you have to be too strict. I'll probably delete all the clips, too. We'll just keep, like, the important stuff, like the TOS talk.
Actually, hold... Yeah, keep going. Go on.
Well, they're still setting up, but if you need to say something, you could say it now while they're setting up.
No. Actually, before they do it, just don't start yet. I'm gonna check one thing. Okay.
He's getting a new scene, so he can put it over his screen, so only you get That's banned fine. When it's actually against the rules.
There we go. I don't know how this works when I do it in the middle. It probably doesn't enable it, but I think that'll be good. So I think I just disabled the automatic publishing of the VOD, so that way I have more time to download it if I want to.
Yeah, you can do that.
All right, I'm ready.
All right, Sam, whenever you're ready to start.
I know that song.
We can park. They would choose fucking Numb out of all songs. Not sexual? It's not sexual, chat! Pole dancing class. Hey man, they're not gonna ban me with Dan in the chat. Dude. We got Dan Clancy to watch a pole dance on stream. Like, this is definitely a W, man. To Linkin Park. I love Sam. They're strong. Oh, dude, Twitch. Dude. Hey, keep in mind, I warned about this, and Dan was like, no, it's fine. It's okay. Dan wanted to see this, all right? I mean, it's not, this isn't sexual. Yeah. This is definitely a nerfed Sam, I will say that much. This is a very nerfed Sam. Sam is being on their best behavior. So yeah, they They're so they all their stuff is wireless, obviously, or else they'd be dead. But yeah, basically there's a community of pole dancers in VR chat that can like do that stuff, which is pretty insane.
Wow, that's very impressive.
This is now, them Rob, calmed down too.
Rob, do you have a full 3D suit and all that too?
I do actually. I don't have a pole though, if I'm gonna be honest. Okay. I've actually broken my collarbone playing this game, trying to do a dance move.
Nice.
Yeah.
So, and do people know where you live or not?
I hope not.
God, I hope not.
I sure hope not.
No, meaning what city? They don't know what city you live.
Yeah, they know I'm in Austin right now.
Oh, they do. That's what I meant. I'll probably be living there for a month, the second half of March and the first half of April. So it'd be fun to come see you.
Dude, you should come by. Yeah. We can either do like a VR stream or, you know, whatever. You can hop in VR. I'll have to clean my room.
There you go.
Getting to experience it inside VR is like a totally different world versus desktop.
Yeah. Tell me, actually, I'll ask all of y'all this question, and I know that it's like, what is the feeling about the new Quest? Do people like, is it still, is Meta looked down upon because they come so late, or do the people like the new Quest?
Okay, so there's a joke in VR chat. If someone uses Quest, you call them Questies, because the Quest is a little more casual. Like some of the older Quest models, like they can't even load certain avatars because they don't have the technology. Tupper, that man over there, probably knows a lot more than I do about like the new Quest and stuff like that. Tupper, can you answer that question since you're like a super epic developer for VR chat?
I'm glad that's my title. Nice to meet you, by the way, Dan. But like by what they think of the Quest, I mean, it's a pretty widely used headset, right? Like the Quest 2, the Quest 3, lots of people here, I'm sure, are using like some variant of them or an Index or something like that. It's pretty good. The key difference is like there's the Quest standalone, which is just the headset itself, right? Like running on the CPU that's built into the headset. And then there's connecting it to a PC, which is like where your everything explodes. You can access tons more stuff because, you know, you've got a huge GPU and a huge CPU that you can just dump, you know, tons of avatars and worlds and stuff into.
Nerd.
So it's a great entry point. I don't like when people are kind of like, I think the term questy is cute.
Damn questies.
But I don't like when people are, yeah, I don't like when people or derogatory with it. I mean, everybody starts somewhere. Right?
I'm joking.
Because I'm sure, I'm sure there are a lot of folks in my chat who've not, you know, been to VR chat
fucking
before.
Questies.
You know, this is all new to them, right? And so probably one of their big questions is, oh, this is really cool, okay, but it'd be great to see this in, you know, in a VR, in VR, and it seems like right now,
what's up, Firo?
The Quest, they're aggressively pricing it all over the place.
They sure are.
Is it for the price? Because I assume for the sets that many of you have, it's much more expensive than the Quest, correct?
Yeah, you're talking to a bunch of power users here. I'm sure everybody here has spent thousands upon thousands of dollars on their setup, myself included.
Right.
But you don't have to do that, right? And that's what you're getting at. Like, you get the Quest for a VR experience is like a great first jump in. It's
right.
I mean, everybody can have their opinions about Meta and whatever, but I mean, honestly, the hardware in a vacuum is no one else could do that. But that being said, I mean, we're doing like a mobile version that anybody can use now. I mean, you don't even need a computer, or you don't even need a VR set. If you have a computer, you could play VR chat. You're doing it right now, right, in desktop mode.
Yeah, I know. But the one thing that like everyone was saying in my chat, which I think makes sense, when you were watching the particle dancing, it's one thing to be watching it on your computer. It's another thing if you're watching it in a VR.
Oh, yeah.
It's a huge difference. Huge difference.
It is, yeah, it's massive. Like, I'm sure, like, there's, maybe you guys were going to go buy Treehouse, I don't know, if not. Like, that's still my standard, like, blow people's minds kind of place. But that seeing that on just a flat square, sure, whatever. But you were surrounded by, I think one of the dances had, like, one of the, like, the screen space kind of flying through stuff shaders in it. But, like, that, yeah, that one was really cool. where it just renders stuff infinitely in every direction. And on a screen, it's meh, but in a headset, it's very different. Hard to describe. It's, I'm reminded of...
Let's assume I was buying something, right? And I'm buying it on my own dime.
I use an index chat.
Play around.
I recommend an index.
All the time. The Quest 3 isn't a bad choice.
No, not at all. Actually, the Quest 3 is an even better choice now, not because of... I mean, Meta's done a great job with their hardware, but then Valve came along and released Steam Link, which allows you to no brain cells required. You click a button, you install the app, you click connect, and it's connected to your gaming PC, if you have one. And now you have PC VR. Like, it's crazy good.
Are there any options in buying a Quest this one or get that version? Or get any options?
It's just file. I think it's just like drive size, right? Like it's 512 terabyte or whatever.
Yeah.
So just depends on how much you're going to install and try out. Quest is a good choice.
Well, I might go ahead and get one. Although I will say I shiver when I do it because the whole Meta thing and the renaming of it, I just like it.
You could go with an Index as well. An Index is a good headset as well. That's what I use. What, you don't like the Index?
As much of a Valve shill as I am. No, I love the Index, dude. But like as much of a Valve shill as I am at this point, like I don't want to get into, you know, what everybody thinks about what's coming next from Valve or whatever, but like the Index is great, but recommending it right now is really hard. And I have so much Valve hardware in my house, so I want you to understand how much it pains me to have to say that out loud on a stream.
Interesting.
Part of it too is I assume the Valve Index is
Is the Index outdated? So I'm old news.
It's more expensive, and it's not the benefit is like the
wait, so Quest 3 is better than the Index?
I suspect Valve will probably come out with.
Should I get a Quest 3?
Long, right?
Yeah. No, it's weird and it's complicated because it's not just a choice into like a specific product, right? Like the Quest is a good idea, but then also Index uses this thing called lighthouse tracking, which is what I'm using now, and pretty much everybody here is also using that's in VR, where there's emitters all around your room. They're just little boxes that you screw into your wall or put on a shelf or duct tape up. I've seen that. But that ecosystem lets you do this. It lets you have trackers. And there are a couple of different systems that allow you to not have to use Lighthouse, like Slime, which is an IMU tracker, or Vive just released a universal tracker. It looks pretty promising, just camera stuff. But really, like, what I'm getting at is because you buy into, like, the Index thing, you kind of naturally flow into full body.
Good thing I let him talk about this instead of me.
If you're really interested, you'll do that. But if you kind of know that you're just going to be a casual user...
I would have just told him to get an Index.
Yeah. With the Index is... If I wanted to go and create a full body avatar and experience, then it seamlessly is into it. Whereas if I got a Meta and then later on say, oh, I want to go full body, then I'm going to go ahead and buy a Valve.
What do you mean my job? I invited him here to do this. Like, technically, by him doing that job, he is doing my job.
Yeah, there are ways to work around that. But from a very high altitude perspective, yeah, generally, that's kind of how it goes. You can mix and match, but it's... Man, it's a pain in the butt. I've done it.
I'm not going to do that.
Right. Index is very user-friendly. Right. It's just kind of pricey.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Meaning, if I was price insensitive, then you'd say,
Quest.
Index.
Oh, well, if you're price insensitive, like, it depends.
No. If I'm price insensitive.
New ones will come and take their place.
Then you'd say, go with the Index.
Oh man, if you're price insensitive, I actually have a whole guide that I've written up for like a computer and then like the VR headset and the trackers and everything. And it's I mean, price insensitive
I'm not really price insensitive. I didn't mean it like, let's do this. Let's go see some other cool stuff and then Rob will connect
you
can send me some of that stuff.
Yeah. I can give you a recommendation. All right. There are a couple different options. Some people suggested we could go to like the VR Chat arcade. There's a big arcade world with a lot of mini games and fun things that we can explore. There are actual games within VR Chat that you can play if you want to play a game within VR Chat, like I don't know. There's all sorts of like fun games, like murder and stuff.
Among Us,
Prison
murder
Escape.
Mystery.
Right. It seems to me, I mean, in general, playing a game like Among Us at some point would be fun, but it seems like it's most fun to be doing things where we're interacting with people and moving around versus like getting into a game right now, is my sense. Like, bring me around to see cool stuff and to interact with people.
I think the arcade map would be pretty good, don't you, Crumpet?
Oh yeah, I think so, Mr. Gator. Let's do it. I think that sounds like a wonderful idea.
They also have Omegle in VR chat.
Hey, Rob.
Yeah. What's up?
On the topic of Quest, have you shown them the Quest Pro, like, face tracking and eye tracking that, like, Almond and Mori have?
No, I haven't.
Show them the faces.
So nowadays, also, Dan, not only do they have, like, full body tracking, but they also track faces as well. So, like, if someone, like, for example, Mori here, right, they have face tracking. So, like, when they blink or smile or anything, it actually tracks it and puts it on their avatar. So, yeah, do you see how, like, they're moving their face and all that stuff? Like, they're doing all that stuff in real life, and it actually scans all of that and puts it in-game. So everything they do, like, it'll scan it all.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like
so
that.
So it brings
like,
more
that,
life
like
to the character.
The whole 3D suit where I'm moving around, right, I think that's probably getting into more. But the ability to have face tracking and then your hands, because it seems like, you know, moving your feet, it's not that big of a deal to use the control to move your feet. But
I'll tell you, meet a really nice dancer, maybe.
Yeah, so we'll go to the arcade. The arcade's pretty cool. There's a lot of cool things you could do in there. Okay, arcade. Cool. Let me just find it really quick. The After Dark arcade, right, Crumpet? That one's the one that...
After Dark Plaza, yep, that's it.
Okay,
that's
I'm
the one.
Invite only. Drop. All right, portal time. I'm going to put it directly in front of you, Dan, actually. Right...
Throw it up, baby.
Here. Right, okay, it's five. Right here. Who the fuck is Dan? He's our boss. He's literally the CEO of Twitch. We are showing the CEO of Twitch VR chat. I don't use VR and VR chat when I'm streaming because it's just easier to stream in desktop mode. I have a full body setup. I know how to use it, but sitting there and like fucking with cameras and all that shit, it's just too much to focus on. I like to be able to read chat. I like to be able to do like... I use VR every single day, but on stream, I stream in desktop mode. It's just easier. Your party is 5 talkers and 40 mutes, but that's literally the best because then you don't have 50 people all talking over each other, like trying to get attention. Whoa, I haven't been here in a while. They changed this.
When they updated this place,
I made it a little bit different, man.
I'll invite Chuck and
games. Do like
hi,
a little
Jufa.
Super game, maybe. Could show him an arcade machine.
Ready to go to the arcade?
You're so cool, Mr. Rumbus.
Thank you, Jufa. Ready to hit up the arcade?
I'm ready.
It's pretty cool. His chin goes inside himself.
Yes.
He looks down.
Alright, let's hit it. See, now you can start role-playing, Dan. If you go to places out there, you know, you could be Gandalf.
That's true, you're a wizard.
I need to figure out who my characters are for this. But now I'll be Gandalf. I need to have a little bit of an older voice with a crappy English accent. Very nice. All right.
I can't do an English. Can I do an English accent? Yes, please. Proceed this way with me, good lad.
All righty, all right. There we go.
Okay, there might be a little bit of walking involved. I don't know where the arcade is anymore. They've changed this place.
I'm an old man, but I can handle it.
Our little stairs, my little legs, this isn't so easy
I
for
like
me.
I like walking. It's
left
okay.
Click.
I get to see this beautiful world.
So click here and just
beautiful
left click to
too.
Enter. Wow, this map has like some pretty questionable FPS. Did he make it through the door? Surely he can figure it out, right? Hold on. Let me go.
He's like joyless.
Crepid, did he... Okay, there we go. All right. So over here we have this big hub. And there's a bunch of different places. There's a theater that you could go to here if you want to watch some movies with friends. There's actually a whole bunch of stuff like that in this game, which we can't really do on Twitch, unfortunately. But there's a big arcade ahead of us. So if we just go straight ahead, there's all sorts of different games and like tokens you can collect and like cool stuff. All right. You can also jump on things and like grind on them and stuff. Show him the robot cyberpunk world. I could, but that world has a lot of exploration in it. All right, and then right over here, just click this door. And then, oh, if you want to run faster, by the way, you could press shift to sprint, and then you run faster. Yeah. So, over here, there's some cool things you could do, like, you could go out and play all sorts of different games and earn prizes. There's like a shooting game here, but you have to buy a gun first before you could use it. You could create a body pillow of yourself here, so you could go here and scan yourself. Face this way. And then you get a body pillow of yourself that you can make and like carry around with you and stuff. Alright, you could click scan right here. And then stare here, and it'll make a body pillow of your model. So stand right there on that little box, and try to move more forward and left. Oh, hold on, let me scan it again. There you go.
There we go.
Does anyone know where the body pillow is? Do you have to buy it? Oh, you have to buy it. So if you look over here, if you play some more games, you can unlock your little body pillow and like carry it around with your model and stuff. Like, you could buy it as, like, a prize over there. You could play pool in here, too.
Okay.
And you can play in pool desktop mode or VR.
Shoot it.
Yeah, let's play. You want to play a pool game against each other?
Pool or shooting or something. Yeah, pool sounds good. I like pool.
All right, let's find the pool tables. One. Where are the pool tables? Oh, shit. Did I lose them? Oh, right here. Okay, so what I need you to do, I need you to come here. And then click, there's like a little power button right here. You click that first. And then on the right, okay, so on the right, I need you to click where it says open slot. I need you to click there.
Okay, hold on, I'm looking. On the right, I see.
There's plenty of open slots at this arcade. Have you seen
all
some of
the way on the right?
Players. Oh.
Yeah, where it says open slot, you want to click that.
Open slot. There we go. I wasn't seeing that. All right, there we go.
Did you click it right? Yes, you did. Okay, cool. So, start game. Alright, I'm gonna break. So, how it works is you go over here, you pick up the stick. And then after you pick up the stick, I'll tell you what to do when it's your turn. It's pretty simple.
Alright.
Mr. Almas, aren't you really bad at pool?
I am not really bad at pool. I'm really good at pool, actually. Okay, I'll have you know. I'm very good.
You lost 3 times in a row.
Yeah, but I lost against really good players, okay? You don't need to call that out. Okay, so now you want
to
pick up...
It's a good opportunity.
You're embarrassing me.
Girls.
Okay,
God,
so...
Boss.
You pick up that stick right there. You click on it. There's like a little circle indicator where you can click on it.
Okay.
Hold Do you on. See the stick? It's like right here. Oh,
yeah.
God, that's Ray's big butt.
Over by you. Let's see. Is it on the table? Oh, there.
It's on the table. You click right there.
Oh, it's on the table. Now I see.
Okay. So click where that little circle is. Yeah.
Hold on. Let me get a little further away. I'm so.
Look where Vray here is pointing, and she'll tell you exactly where to click.
There we go.
And then if you. Okay. So click there, and it'll pick up the table. Pick up the stick. All right. Perfect. All okay, right. So now press E.
Pick up the table.
Press E.
Yeah. And then you should get a top-down view, right?
I got it.
Okay,
yeah,
so you move your mouse left and right to pick the angle.
Open? Are we still open?
Yeah.
Is the table
still
open?
It's open. You can make either one in. So you choose left and right to choose where you want to shoot, and then you hold click when you want to hit the ball, and then while you're holding click, you pull back on your mouse to indicate how much power you want to put.
Okay, meaning on the circle.
Yes.
Oh,
so
I pull back on the not on the circle. I move the mouse. I move the mouse back.
Yes, exactly. So after you click, you just move the mouse back. So usually people would play this in like virtual reality, but since we're deskies, like this is how we would play. It gives us like a little alternative way of playing. So you just click, hold back, and then let go.
I'm pulling back, and it's there. It is. I need to push forward. All right, I got it.
Yeah. Once you let go, it shoots. Wait, did you make it in? Almost.
You got
okay.
This, boss. Woo! All
right.
Who am I talking to? Both my boss.
All right, here we go. My turn.
I made it.
No, you didn't. It's my turn
okay,
now.
Do I have to drop something now or not?
No, you just wait for your turn again.
Keeping this.
Okay, well, I just made one of each in, so I guess it's still open. Okay, I'm going to hit it right here. Okay, I made one of each in again, so it's still... Okay, did I just... I made the 8-ball in and I lost.
I think
wow.
You knocked the 8.
Yeah, that's... Okay, the 8-ball looks...
You go, boss!
The 8-ball isn't even black, it's green!
CEO stuff right there!
The 8-ball is green! Woo! It's not fair! What the hell? It looks like a normal ball!
Alright, Rob, I'll let you do a rematch.
We rematch. Do you want to break this time?
No.
Okay. All right. Click
Actually,
player
I'll break.
Two again.
Sure.
Okay. Okay.
I'll
okay.
Break.
Yeah. Break.
Break
it. Hit one.
I'll break.
It's very sweet of the CEO to allow you to have a rematch after that.
Oh, hit open
so nice
slot one.
So you have to leave the game because you accidentally joined slot two. Leave.
Yeah. Okay.
Click open slot one and then rejoin.
Got it.
Chat. I'm not bootlicking. I didn't know. Okay. Now click start game. Chat, you know I'm competitive. I would never let anyone win on purpose, okay? I am going to
beat him. This guy sunk the 8 just so he could look good in front of Dan. Oh my god.
Okay. Now you pick up the stick on the other side. This one right here.
That was a natural loss.
All right.
All right, now remember the 8-ball is green for some reason here and not black, so that's what threw me off. Okay. So now you press E, and you know how to do it.
Bumping into you,
yeah.
Hi.
So I can't move. Can I move where the cue ball is?
I mean, where you're standing doesn't matter.
On a break, I believe.
Right now,
if you let go.
You can, but you have to do it.
You can pick it up.
Yeah, you have to do it outside of this view.
Okay,
yeah.
I'm not going to do it then. Right. Basically, I moved the cue ball before I'll just do it with this view. I'll go ahead and break in the middle, even though that's not where you normally break.
Yeah, guys, this guy's literally Gandalf, okay? Like, he's using magic. Okay, you got stripes
Woo!
In.
That's Gandalf the Great! Woo!
Does that count as cheating?
No, it does not count as cheating. Okay, so you've got stripes, I think, right? Yeah, you've got stripes.
Yeah. By the way, those things that are, there's some, the one that I just got in that's moving, that's underneath, right?
Yeah, that's underneath. Those are the ones you made it.
Yeah, it's just going down. All right.
Why is Cardo still here? I'm going to beat him, guys. I cannot lose. I have to establish dominance, okay? I have to show him that I'm competent, right? Whenever your boss takes you out and you play a game, you always have to win, right? You have to show that you're competent, that you're not a fucking noob lord. Okay, it's my turn. All right, playtime is over here.
All right, yeah, sure. he speaks a big game, you know.
Listen, Dan, don't think I'm gonna go easy on you.
Interesting, you can make a bet.
Rob, are you good at pool in the real world?
No, I'm a lot better in VR.
Okay.
I don't even know if this is gonna make it in. It'll bounce in at the very least. Okay, that went in. Okay, I'm gonna break these up a little bit. Yeah, that went in. It was so fast you couldn't even see it. try to keep up.
Yeah.
You know, so we could make this game a little more interesting.
Ooh.
That's
what, are you saying like, this game is boring?
You want to make a bet on it?
No, I'm just saying maybe you could wager something, you know? Like, for example, if you were to win, you get a date with Ray, and if Rob wins, he gets Twitch.
There you go. Maybe I'll play my first real game without betting.
Okay.
Am I seeing this right? Hold on, if I'm seeing this right, it's your turn. Okay, no, those are still in. No, I'm looking at all my balls that are still here. All right. I don't want to hit the eight ball in. That's silly.
I'm bad at desktop pool. I literally haven't missed a single ball yet. I just made two balls in accidentally. Dude, that would be a good bet. Like, me being Twitch CEO for one day. How fast would I grow gray hairs? That sounds actually... Nice. That sounds exhausting.
Ooh.
All right. Just, you want to be Twitch CEO the day after we make a policy change that
relates
to sexual content.
That's right.
The day you want to be Twitch CEO. Okay.
That'll be an eventful day. That'll be your day off.
I need to see.
You'll gain 5 years in one day.
Dan does do a good job of like actually being out there. Like, I remember we had a dinner together and Dan was talking about how he wanted to be more involved and he did a really good job. No, I think you just made one in. I think you made it in.
I did make it. Yeah. I thought it bounced out because of the thing underneath.
Am I actually going to unironically lose to his first pull game? Like, surely not, right?
Yeah, he's going to get a date with Ray on this one, man. You're kind of screwing the pooch here.
What is that sound? Oh, it's that game.
Oh my god, I can't believe it.
Ooh, very close.
Yeah, but I don't have the easiest shot ever.
A chance.
I had, if I made that, you were done. You were done if I made that.
I mean, I don't really have a shot here.
Dude,
he's actually insane. You're a pool shark. Okay, let's see.
It's like that episode of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Oh my, okay, I'll take it. Whatever, it went in. That's all that matters.
Cracked out Lucille and Uncle filled your ass.
Okay,
looks like they count slop here.
Did you just call my shot slop? Okay, hold on.
Yeah, it wasn't what you were shooting at. It was slop.
Watch, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bounce this ball off the wall into the middle pocket on the bottom here. All right, easy.
Yeah, boom. Yeah, big talker.
But I also made your shot in.
Yeah,
it was a sick shot. I just accidentally made his shot in two. All right, it's your turn, Dan. Let's see if you can finish me off. Do not give me that sus look.
Damn it.
I'm starting to see there's a little bit of beginner's luck involved here.
Generous of you to give him a shot.
I'm so scared to break these shots because I'm scared it's going to make the eight ball in. Like, I really don't know what to do here.
I know.
I'm going to have to wall shoot it.
Oh yes, you made.
I have made one of your balls in every single time. Oh my god, am I about to lose?
You sure you're not throwing, Rob?
I'm not throwing, dude. I'm trying my hardest.
Hey, it's okay. It's the CEO's first time. You want
to,
you know.
You can press right click to let. If you want, you can move the ball. Okay. Well, whatever you just did, that was not it. Okay, that's fine. You screwed up a little bit, but that's okay because I'm.
I wanted to give you a shot. Now you have a shot. You have a legitimate shot here.
Based on how Rob's been doing, he's probably going to sink your ball for you.
Yeah, I know. Wait, now mine is. It's me again. Did you just miss?
Yeah, I scratched again.
Now I can move the ball? Wait.
I have made a ball in every single time, but I also make my own ball in. All right, you could go for that eight ball.
Do I have ball in hand now?
You can actually move the ball if you want. You just have to press E to leave that screen, and then you could reposition the ball if you want. You could literally just put it right in front of the eight ball and make it in.
Okay, I left it. Let me learn how to do this.
Just click that green triangle above the ball, and you can move it on the table.
Okay, so press right click to let go of the stick. Okay.
Grab that green triangle, and then you just move the ball wherever that triangle is. The ball will be right where you put it.
Yeah, but I right click or left click?
You left click the ball, and then you right click to let go of it when you have it where you want it. Okay, so it looks like you dropped it there. So you have to shoot it from there.
That works. All right. Now I hit E, right?
Now you hit E. Well, you have to pick up the stick. If you you have the stick. Press E.
I picked it up.
Natural.
Firmly grasp it and get ready.
Can I ask you a question, Dan? Oh, GG. Yeah. So you weren't much of a gamer before Twitch, right?
Correct.
So what made you want to get involved with Twitch?
Interestingly, initially, and by the way, didn't I just win?
You won. You beat me. GG.
Yeah, you definitely did.
Ooh. Yeah. I need to do the Victor dance, but since I don't have a 3D thing, it's not.
No, you have a dance animation. You should have one.
Okay. What do I do to do it?
Click expressions the same way you did wave. Press R, and then click expressions, and then it should be somewhere there. Is Dan really going to freaking victory dance on me?
Dance, here we go.
Oh yeah.
Dude, I just got victory dance.
Still have a CC moaning on you.
Dude. Yeah, I just got emoted.
Now going to your question.
Okay.
Going to your question. Yeah. Originally they interviewed me because I had been working at I had left the company I was at before about and so I wasn't working at the time, and Emmett, you know, interviewed me and he said, oh, I think you'd be good. And initially I actually turned it down because I was like, well, I'm not a big gamer, am I really the right person for this? And then he came back like 4 months later and he said, no, Dan, we really think you're the right person. And I said yes. Eventually I said yes because I like the people I was going to work with. And one thing I've learned is if you're working with people you like, then in general you're happy. If you're working with people you don't like, you're unhappy. But I really didn't understand the community part of Twitch because I wasn't a gamer, so I didn't spend a lot of time. And it's just sort of synergistic that Twitch actually fits my background really well because I've done a lot of community stuff. And
right.
Then I also was a theater major undergrad, so the whole performance and improv part is very natural to me. But I didn't know that when I said yes.
Chad, I have him 150%.
Right. I just thought it was an interesting problem, and it ended up being an extremely good fit.
That's cool. Yeah, I can tell that you're like you're a bit of like a role player. You should come by. So what we do, and I pretty much like every streamer has done this once. We do this like elimination show. Where you can come by and then a bunch of people play different characters, right? And you meet them one by one and you pick like which character you thought was the best. And then like, so it's like three rounds, right? In the first round, you eliminate like five people who you find like to be the worst characters. In the second round, they do a talent show and they all show you their talents. You eliminate like five more characters. And then at the end, like each of them like come by and like give you like a speech as to why they think they should win, and you pick the winner. You should come try it sometime. It's really fun.
I'd do that. That'd be fun.
Okay.
That'd be fun. I have a question. So right now, for example, for all the people that like the girl on the my left across the table from you, who's dancing right now? Is she dancing like, or she or he? Standing there dancing in their outfit while they're dancing?
Yeah, so everyone moving in real life. If there's actual arm and leg movements, right. They're moving in real life like that. That's literally them.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
And they basically just have
me
it.
Too.
So, because they have the whole set on, so they're standing up, they're moving around. Got it.
Yep. It's a good way to stay in shape.
That's very true. Yeah. They have whole dance clubs that are dedicated to learning how to dance in VR, and it's pretty intensive and crazy.
We should hit up the club sometime.
It does occur to me that if I'm going to get gear, if they're like getting it so that you can be in 3D, Because it just seems a lot more fun if you're in 3D.
Oh, it's a huge difference. The difference between being like, we call it like half body or full body is night and day. It's a huge difference. Do you want to say something, Element? What's up? Oh, are you doing the chat box or are you signing? Oh, I...
Does he speak sign language?
No, he doesn't speak
sign language. I do not speak sign language.
There is a big...
A lot of people in VR chat are, yeah, big sign language users because it's so easy to express yourself.
We also have an entire sign language community in VR.
Yeah, nice. So...
My uncle taught at Gallaudet, and my aunt taught sign language, but I never learned sign language.
They have worlds in VR chat where you can learn sign language, and they have VR, correct me if I'm wrong, VR chat has its own like version of sign language, right? Where like you could like a specific version for VR chat.
Yes.
Cause there are a lot of people that don't want to like talk in VR chat. Like they want to keep, you know, themselves like anonymous. Right. So, they end up, learning sign language to communicate with each other. And there's like classes and stuff. It's a huge thing in this game. I don't personally do it because I'm too lazy to learn another language. I'm already bilingual, but there's a lot of people that do it. So yeah, it's pretty cool. And they have classes for that and stuff.
Yeah.
If you want,
nice.
I kind of wanted to show you, there's one more like visualizer world where it like takes over your whole screen that like I've shown like everyone on their first day. Yeah, I want to show you this because I think it looks really cool. I was going to show them Audio Hell because we've showed that to pretty much everyone on their first day and everyone seems to like that, right?
Yeah, for sure. It's crazy and awesome. Particles everywhere. I think that'd be fun.
Okay. This is definitely a seizure warning thing. So if anyone has epilepsy, this is going to be kind of wild. All right. Like definitely don't want to look at the next thing coming up.
Particle.
All right. Let me find this Particle Hell. Kind of was Particle Hell.
One of the most fun parts of VR chat is just being able to see everyone's different avatars and how they like choose to look, right? Because then you really realize some people choose to look really pretty and some people just like being really weird.
Yeah, we have some pretty ugly friends. Okay, right here.
What is that supposed to mean?
Right here, there's a portal. I just have to go through this portal.
Yep.
Did it work?
No, you missed it.
It looks like Dan's having fun. Do you guys think Dan's having fun so far? He beat my ass in pool. He actually was really good. But I was kind of like... I was kind of rushing every turn. I wasn't like setting up my ball so that it would land. Like, you know, I wasn't doing any of that stuff. I'm using the male avatar, huh? Well, my female avatar's got like under boob and...
Son,
you know.
Bitch.
What's wrong with you?
Fucking lighting, man.
Yeah.
The lighting.
Oh. Oh, if the face this way to do it.
Oh no, I can't fix it. Oh no, I can't fix it.
Paladin one doesn't? True.
This world looks so Rob, cool. When are we showing him the Carnoverse? Is that happening tonight?
Yeah, we'll save the Carnoverse for next time.
What about Bread World?
Did you watch Loki?
Alright, okay.
What about,
we'll can we show him the world
time.
With the giant furry that eats you and like swallows you whole? Like, could we do that one?
Okay.
Yeah, we'll save that for next time.
Okay.
Oh, hey, I got that avatar. You know, I showed you it earlier. I think he's
talking to me. What's up?
Where you bring me around VR chat? What if I do get all the gear, at some point we should do it where you bring me around VR chat. We're not streaming. So then you can show me all the stuff that we have to worry about.
I would love to show you everything. I could give you the full tour. I think you'll have a blast. Honestly, it'll be super fun.
Yeah, but you'd always.
We'll hit up a club together. There's actual dance clubs with a whole bunch of people. You could go up to random people and just socialize with them. There's dancers everywhere. It's very immersive. It feels like you're like in an actual club.
I'll need to make sure I have a full setup though, because if I'm doing that, I want to be immersive and I want to be able to dance, not sitting at a keyboard.
Yeah. Yeah, we could definitely help you out with that. So if you do come to Austin, I could show you here how all that stuff works, and then when you get it yourself, you know, you'll kind of get an idea of what it's all like.
I actually may be there. Now I'm pretty busy that weekend, but I may be there the 19th to the 22nd of January. So,
cool. Yeah. So within the next month, that sounds awesome.
Yeah.
We should do a cooking stream together.
There's a penguin behind me.
That's Wooks.
Penguin.
So this penguin has been in our lobby for 4 years, and he's never said a word once. No one knows what he sounds like. We don't know anything about him. He's literally just a penguin in VR chat, and he plays a penguin the whole time. He's never talked to us one time in 4 years. 5 years, even, actually. Yeah, he's just a penguin. Okay, so let me show you how this world works. This is a visual world. Actually, sorry, did you want
to
say something?
I have a question before you get to the world. Yeah, last question. So, of all the folks hanging out now, how many of them are streamers?
Raise your hand if
most
you're a streamer.
Of them, I'd say
most of them.
In the VR chat category, Crumpet's probably the biggest streamer after me. Crumpet gets a good amount of viewers.
Kind of
he's
like
a very, very successful streamer. Oh, and then there's a lot of, you know, fairly successful streamers around here, too.
Right, right. All right. Explain the world now.
Crumpet is also the number one RP-er. Okay, so this is a visual world.
He's flattering me.
What you do is you go out here and you just stare, okay? It's a visualizer. It looks really cool in desktop mode. It looks even better in VR mode, but it's still something really cool to see. I think this is something that everyone should see at least once in VR chat, okay? So there's going to be music playing. You're going to see a bunch of stuff on your screen. Just enjoy the show, all right? I'm going to put it on right now. Should I just do them all or should I start off on like a certain one? I'll just do them all, I guess.
He's already kind of dying. I'm looking in the distance.
Guys, I don't have master. Someone else loaded in before me, so you guys need to click here, because I don't know who has it.
It's probably
skill issue.
I gotta DM you something.
Which one were you clicking?
It's me.
Oh, someone else got it.
Alright.
Oh god, my eyes.
So now, you could just stand down here and look, and, you have your... You can hear the music, right? Like, there's music playing for you?
Yeah.
Alright, cool.
Oh, I'm pink now.
I'm gonna
get that checked
red
out.
Red and green.
So, I don't know how well your internet is gonna handle the bitrate on this, to be honest. Hopefully, decently enough. This might get a little blurry on your screen. Really great if you're on drugs as well.
Burn out of my soul in VR. Oh my gosh.
Jack, can my bitrate handle it?
Jesus.
It's really hard for our OBS to capture this.
Oh my god!
Mr. Omis, I think I'm blind.
Yeah. Is it in VR? That's right, you are in VR.
Yeah. it's very wicked in VR. Holy moly. Oh my goodness.
That's pretty dang.
So imagine animations Jesus like that, Christ. But you're at a club, right? And there's like lights everywhere and there's people dancing everywhere. Like that's usually the type of atmosphere it is, right? When you go to like some of these like clubs. It's pretty cool.
That is cool.
Yeah. There's a couple more of these, but I don't want to like take too much time on this. I'll probably do one more. This one's a little more immersive. So this one actually requires you to walk.
Nice.
So what's going to happen is a giant ramp is going to appear in front of you. We're all going to go to the top of the ramp, and there's going to be this giant like gun at the top. Click it to pick it up, and wherever you move that gun around, it's going to shoot particles after a while that are just going to like make these crazy animations everywhere. All right?
All right.
I'll explain everything as it's happening. I think it's this one. Let's see. It should be this one. Oh, whoever has... Yeah, thanks.
It actually handled it real... Oh, God. No, no.
Okay. This way, Dan.
Yes.
Dan, I need you to hold that ship button and run up this way. This is probably the best one, honestly. He was stomached by Bray. Hey, you know what? I don't blame him. After this, we'll have Dan do his music performance. What's the map? It's called Particle Hell. Just search Particle Hell. Poor guy, dude. Poor guy. I wasn't sure if he handled this. Well, Bray is officially Dan's mood, you know? Alright, is he gonna make it up here? Where is he? There he is. Alright, do you see this big thing here, Dan? You gotta click this and pick it up. Come here, Dan. Alright, click right here on this thing. Cool. Alright. You have to hold the left click. So go to it again and click it. There should be like a blue box that appears. Try to click it and hold it. Nice. Okay, so now you can here, hold on, I'll bring it back to you. That's some of the more visual stuff involved in this game. And there's definitely like there's so much stuff you can do in this game. There's exploration maps, there's horror maps, there's so many things. A lot of the stuff takes like hours to go through because it's like storyline based, so it's not really stuff that I could show you today. But definitely if you want to like plan some more stuff like that in the future, we could definitely make that happen, especially when you get VR. We could do like an adventure map or a horror map or even some kind of a role play scenario and stuff like that.
Play the Devouring with the Twitch sheet, yeah.
Dude, yeah. We could. It would be great. If you want, there's one more thing that we could show you, and then maybe you could do your little music performance. And they have this like
sounds good.
There's a VR museum where they show you like things made in virtual reality, right? So all the art there is made in virtual reality. It's super cool looking, super immersive. Would you like to check that out before you do your performance?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Do
you guys remember what that map is called? The one that has like that big Phoenix thing? I know. What's his name? Mr. Panda has it.
It's like VR art museum, isn't it?
Something like that, yeah. VR museum. Do you like? Have you ever played a horror game before?
I haven't, but I'm game for anything.
Dude, we should do a horror map sometime. That could be a lot of fun. Okay, here we go.
Some pretty good ones. Smiler.
Okay.
Hold on. Oh yeah. If you get VR for that, that would be crazy. Oh my gosh. It's so different to have like monsters chasing you in VR, and it's like everything's dark and no matter where you look, there's something coming at you. So crazy.
One second. Is that the one that has that big the big phoenix where like you can make the paintings like smaller and bigger and you can literally like enter the paintings? Is that the one?
I don't know if that's the one, but the one I sent you is you click on the paintings and it teleports you to like each exhibit.
The Museum of VR Painting, is that it? Okay, let me see. Hold on. VR Painting. Yeah, I think this is it. Okay, I'm gonna drop a portal. Guys, there's only 32 slots here, so let Dan go in first and we'll see. If you make it in, you make it in. Alright, Dan, there's a portal right here. Where is he?
I don't think Wamp is making it in.
Four people are being left behind.
Okay, did he make it through? Okay, he did. This map is actually really freaking cool. Dan's FOV is set bad. Well, we'll show him this. Then he's gonna do a music performance. I don't know what I just entered during that last song, but I love it here. Well, thank you. Every first message in my chat is spammed by fucking copy. Why don't I should just disable the first message thing. Because then people like see that and then they just leave forever. They're like, oh shit, that felt weird. Okay.
Oh, this map.
Oh my god.
Yeah, this map's really nice.
Yeah, this place is sick.
Guys, as a VR degenerate, I'm doing my best to show other side of VR chat to Dan. Hopefully I'm doing okay. My life is going to H parties and RPing and watching people throw back their fat butts. So I'm doing my best. If you guys have any suggestions for stuff to do next time, just let me know.
And so, Rob, the way it works is there are all these locations, and then you control... Anytime you're going to a location, you're controlling who is at that location with you, although some of the locations are purely public places. Is that right?
So, how it works is... When you're in here, you can choose any place that you want to go to. They're all published by creators, and they have like a set amount of slots that they allow in that world, right? And once you make it, you could choose what kind of an instance it is. It could be a public one where literally anyone joins. It could be a private one like this where you only invite your friends. Or it could be like a friends of friends situation where people can only join if they know someone that you know, right? And that's like the general consensus, right? Oh, there's one more thing I want to show you sometime. There's a guy who plays this game who's recreated every single game show pretty much in VR chat. Like Family Feud, The Price is Right, a whole bunch of that stuff. If you want, we could literally do a Family Feud game like on stream. Like we could play a full game. Like
That'd be a blast. That'd be a blast.
Do you want to check out this map for a second and then play a Family Feud game?
That works for me. Let's do the museum here. Yeah.
All right, cool. All right, let's check it out. All right, just follow me this way. This is going to require you to walk around a little bit. So if I recall correctly, all the art done on this map is actually done within VR. So that's a pretty cool thing to know.
Yeah.
Thank you, Rainier, for the 20 bomb, dude. That's fucking huge, man. All right, so we just walk right through here. Yeah, so here's the first exhibit, like, and then you just keep walking through, and then you look at all the different exhibits, and you can see all the cool things that people have made. So here's like a really cool trippy thing you could do. You see how this is like an art piece right here? You can click this button, and it brings the art piece to life, and someone can literally go into it and become part of the art piece itself. Yeah,
you'll be trapped there forever, never be able to get out.
So yeah, and then you could like click it and make it small again, so you could see all of it like up close. Yeah, it's
very cool.
All right, and then we could go to the next one if you'd like. Nancy's trying to see some ash jiggle. Well, he came to the right place. And then every single thing here, you could just like go into the exhibit itself, right? You could click it, see it up close and personal. It's all 3D. And this is another one of those things that are just super cool in VR, right? Like another one of those things that you should get a headset for.
He showed up with Samwise Avatar and I lost it.
You're true calling.
I looked to my left and
was right, the
they have a horse. They have a horse frog.
You have an obsession with horses, I swear.
Yeah.
Does Clancy have his FOV on 150?
It's so majestic.
Where do you edit your FOV? I can teach him how to bring up his FOV. I only have 72 degrees. Oh,
I don't know if you can. Okay,
I don't think it's his FOV. It's his. Yes, you can. But I don't think it's his FOV. I think it's his resolution. He's playing like on a big screen. Yeah, I think it's his FOV chat, like, or his resolution.
I did Oh, it may be. Hold on. I went ahead and went to full screen. Maybe it's better if I'm not in full screen. I bet you that's what happened. I went into full screen. Because I thought it was cool. When you were doing the psychedelic stuff, I was in full screen. And I bet you that messed up.
Yeah, that's probably what happened. What you can do is just go to OBS and then remember how you did the stretch to fit to screen. Try doing that again like you did last time.
I think it's... Let me just see. I think it's fine now that I've gone.
I wonder if he eats a
hot dog. I think it's fine now.
Okay, cool. All right, right
Hello,
this way.
Hello,
so you're gonna have to walk through the walls a little bit here. Another cool thing here, yeah. It's crazy to think that someone just used like a 3D marker and just drew all of this in VR, right? And then we go through here to continue. I think. No, this isn't where we go. We click here. We click here on this window, I think.
We're stuck.
Yeah, okay. Did he make it through? Okay, there we go.
Yeah, I did.
Right this way. I know sometimes it's hard with all the clicking and stuff, especially since you're new to all this. All right, and then we just go across right to here.
I jumped out a window and left.
The RP walk. All right, this one's really cool as well. I love this one a lot. This one's like a big dragon. He knows about the ship key, I told him. Alright, right this way. Well, y'all don't use motion capture suits. Well, he's gonna come over and I'm gonna literally show him. Except I'm not gonna let him use VR in my room. Ain't no way. He's gonna have to go to Stephanie's room. Is he stuck? Stepsis? Dude, I just got a 121-month sub. That's crazy. Dan, do you want to hear something crazy? Yeah. I just got a 121-month sub. Isn't that crazy? Think about that. Over wow. 10 years. That's insane.
That's
All right.
great.
Right
That's
this way.
Amazing.
Dude, that is absurd. That's so long. 10 years and a month. I wonder what's the longest someone has subbed to someone. That's got to be like one of the longest. This one's super pretty. Alright.
This one's nice. I like this one.
Oh my god.
Yeah, we've got a few more of these to go. This one's really cool because it engulfs you into the art. I don't know how to explain it. It's really nice. It feels super immersive. Furry Booger, thank you for the 5-bomb, dude. Thanks for supporting me for so long, dude. Deer! It's Wampy! Octopus! This is so trippy, actually. It's kind of a point of pride of you at this point. Nah, I feel you, dog. I don't know where we go from here. Do we click something? Are we supposed to click something in here? Or do
the
we go
orb?
This way?
The orb, the Dragon Ball!
You gotta click.
Oh, okay, click the orb that it's holding, this little purple orb right here in its hand. Perfect. He deserves his own sub badge. He has like the rarest one. I don't know what this is. Do we just walk forward? Can you press this button? I can't press it. Hold on. I guess we just keep walking. Oh, cool.
And we made it to the finale.
And this is the final one, Dan. This is the crazy Phoenix one. Right? Yeah, I love this one a lot.
Imagine the click on this thing. Holy.
The what? Actually, he's so sick. Okay, what were we going to show him, chat, after this?
You were going to do
Family Feud.
Price is Right or
Family Feud, yes. Okay, let me make sure that there's someone here who could run the game, because it's a little hard to run. I want to make sure that it's actually runnable. You can run it?
Yeah, I've messed around with it before.
All right, perfect. All right, we're going to go do some Family Feud, all right?
All right, Family Feud.
Woo! I'll host it. All right. Does that mean you need to have a lead? Like, does that mean you have to go through first? Does it matter?
I don't think so. I think the buttons can be used by anyone.
Okay.
But it's just Portal, like for syncing.
Portal's
like
behind you, Dan. This should be really fun. Thank you, Dare, for the 67-month sub. This is so fun. I'm glad you guys are liking it. All right. Okay. If you guys want to play and can talk, please go on the stage, okay? And then we'll divide you guys into teams. Alright. Alright, so Dan, we'll make your team on this side here. And then we'll put another team. We'll make Crumpet have a team on the other side. Unless, we could actually just put you on Dan's team, because you've been a good guide for him the whole time. You can make sure, you know, he knows what's going on. Alright.
Alright, I'm down for whatever, bro.
You're on Dan's team, alright?
Yo, what up, my
You're
family
a mute.
Member?
You're a mute. You're up, well, you have AI here. Voice.
Yeah, we're probably gonna have to kick the butts of everyone
Jimby,
on the other
you
team.
Can join that team.
Yo, we're definitely doing that. Alright, we are winning this thing.
What are you saying, Anna?
I agree. I hit my hand IRL.
I'm down to play.
Whew. Nice okay. Fine, alright. All right, Matt, join this team. All right, you will use vocal cords for this.
Don't worry, we're professionals at this. I've lost only three out of the five
Brad,
games I played. So I
join
think
on this side right. as well.
Wow.
Okay, so in Family Feud fashion, you guys do have to start off behind the little thing over there. Like, we have to introduce you guys. Hold on. Mimikyu, can you open the thing?
Oh, yeah.
I'll follow him.
The doors.
Into this?
Yeah, that thing's going to open, because this is the old school Family Feud where it starts off behind there. All right, so you got to start off behind there. We're going to announce the teams, and that's when you can come out. I guess you can make that the Clancy family, all right? And then on the other side, Jufa, you want to play? Do you have a voice?
All right, sit down, son. I'm getting on your lap.
We need more talkers, guys.
I do.
All right, I'll carry you up.
All right, if you can talk, please come up here and play. All right, Shmoopy. Jufa,
I will carry
play?
The ring.
All right, Shmoopy, come here. Jufa, come here. Adam, you said you can use voice for this?
Or a step stool or something.
Okay, Mew, do you have a voice?
Ooh, you're up against Frodo. Natural
okay,
enemy.
You go there
I
too.
You can handle it.
Go behind the thing.
Frodo's not my enemy.
Oh, sorry.
He's a buddy.
Yeah,
we're
they
friends.
Are actually. They are
well,
actually
you're
homies.
Have to totally toast your buddy for this.
We're a fellowship.
We need one more person.
Okay, Frodo's
Adam, go behind the thing over there. Adam,
ooh,
over there.
Yeah, we'll
over
use
there,
that
Adam.
Against him.
Close the door.
Adam, run, Adam. We need one more player. Anyone else? Come on, guys. Don't be shy. Give me one more player. Oh, all right. Thank you, Valerie.
Four against
good
three.
Shit, Valerie.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
What's
right over there.
Name?
Make that family. Yeah, go ahead, Schmidt. Where do you want your family? All right. Team Frodo. All right.
The Crumpets? The Crumpets?
You can be the Crumpets. Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess we'd be the Baggins.
The
is that right?
Thank you. I appreciate it. That also means
oh,
if
yeah,
I
Baggins.
Lose, it's on me, too. South so that's like a Carolina. Smart business maneuver.
There you
CEO
go,
maneuvers.
The yeah. Crumpet sounds like.
All right,
you will have to bear with me because I don't remember every single little.
So maybe no,
that's fine, Mimikyu.
Hell yeah.
All right, all you'll have to do is hit the song, and then
thank you very much.
Open the things as I introduce the families.
Very much.
Okay. All right.
There. Thank you very
much. This is Family Feud episode 420. air date right now.
Welcome to Family Feud! food. On yeah, this we side, is. We I have the none, Crumpet huh? family. Come on out. Open the Crumpet family yeah! thing, please.
Open the door.
Open the door.
You gotta open the door for us. Woohoo!
Come on out.
Yeah, let's go.
Hey,
we're so excited, partner.
We're gonna win this thing.
And on the other side,
Sam Rowie is.
We have the Baggins family. Come on down.
Oh.
Boo, boo.
What?
Boo,
boo, boo. It's time to play America's favorite game show.
They're going down. They're going down.
All right. I need... Frodo, I need Crumpet. Come here in the middle.
Wait. Swap with me, Gandalf. You gotta go up against your natural, right, like, little
I'll
hobbit
go
friend.
Against Frodo.
Okay. All right. You guys He's know how Family Feud down. Works, right?
No.
Yep.
I'm Let's do
hit
it.
The button.
Wait, you can't hit the button until I ask the question, all right? Mimikyu, I need
I
the
know.
Prompt.
Where's the prompt
all
button?
Right.
I don't know. Find the prompt button.
Oh, no.
The
can run this.
What?
No, it doesn't appear when I grab
the prompt. The appears pressure. When you grab the card.
That's not true.
The pressure.
Oh.
It's not true.
Okay, face off time. There we go.
We have the song again. Okay, sorry, technical difficulties. Woo-hoo! The person who usually run this is on vacation for holidays.
Damn.
Oh, maybe we have to advance the camera. Hold on, I got it.
Okay, we're figuring this out.
There's three people over there trying to run it.
Okay.
Is there maybe a step stool?
Sorry, no. You're gonna have to reach.
Okay, okay? No, that's fine. That's okay.
Yeah.
We have to reach up his little arms to hit the button.
Where's XCon? He knows how to run this. Oh my god, the last video XCon linked me. Whew, I can't watch that.
I guess I should be Gandalf in this, and not some guy from the south, since I'm playing against the Baggins, so I will be Gandalf.
You two get to know each other. I'm gonna figure out how to start the game.
Alright.
Gandalf.
Yes, Frodo, it's been a long time since we've seen each other.
It has. I haven't seen you.
Do you? I don't know. I don't know what the but. Do you see, like, a start game button?
XCon's coming.
Oh. That bag end, as you know,
I don't need to know that.
Well, I've been wandering across all the worlds and visiting with the elves.
It's okay, they're RPing. They're buying us some time.
That ring in there. Good morning.
Okay, good.
Much calmer now. It's much calmer.
This is Big G point of view, huh? This is interesting.
I think, potentially, they might be... The buttons might matter to the master of the world.
That's okay.
I think for, like, the bomb stuff.
Unfortunately, you know, the Shire...
Oh, yeah, who got here first?
...got the worst end of the
Fuck
whole
if I know,
ordeal.
Probably Dan.
That's why I was wondering if you're actually living in the Shire. Does the Shire...
Man, they're really getting into this RP.
No.
Yeah, they should definitely bring him for, like, date night.
What do you guys want me to do? Everyone else is super low, and you guys keep complaining about it.
That's right.
Oh, dude, he would kill it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, XCon is coming, and he knows how to run this. At worst case scenario, if Master has to start it, then we'll just remake the instance and have XCon be lead.
Looky, looky.
Why is he in 2 minutes? What
Deal.
Do you think he's doing right now? He's in VR chat. Yeah, probably. It's interesting how when I asked him to join Silent K, it also joined. So he's probably cleaning up.
Hey, Rob.
Oh my God.
While he's distracted, I just wanna make sure we thank the subs, Rob.
What the hell?
Just Rob, while Big Man Dan is distracted. hey, thanks guys for supporting the stream.
Rainier gifted a 20 bomb. This doesn't even work right. Wait, but that's sick.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, sorry though. It's not like Twitch and great. I just threw it together, Lamar.
That's actually a good idea.
It works really good.
We need to get some of those
and also,
for, like, Tufan Mori.
Technically, like, it's not an oxynake in the mouth.
I know. I was able to see the straps. Okay. I'll be right back. Keep trying to figure out.
Oh my god! Wait, I got it!
Out?
It's working!
Okay, good job, good job.
I just have to rotate.
Right.
Okay.
Alright, guys.
Golem, and you did have a sort of way with each other.
Thank you for the fiver. All right, guys, yeah. Are you guys ready to play the feud?
We're ready, Rob.
All right, I am ready.
Yeah. All right, top seven questions are on the board. You can buzzer in when you have an answer. Name something a teen wouldn't be able to go a day without. Yes.
What is the one ring, Rob?
Is one ring on the board?
Good answer.
No, absolutely not. Okay, what is your answer, Dan?
Water.
All right, water. Is water on the board?
Oh, shit.
Okay, I'm afraid that's not an answer, okay? Well, we're going to move on. This is teen specific, all right? I think all humans can go on without water. Jufa, what is your answer?
Yes, I thought you said team.
Salami.
Seriously. Is salami on the board?
What's the question?
I thought it's
okay.
Hey.
Do you guys want to pass
teen,
or play?
Teenage?
We want to play, Rob.
Teenager. All right. The Baggins team is going to play, okay? All right, guys. Name something a teenager wouldn't be able to go a day without. Mew, VR.
I'm going to say telephone.
Is it on the board?
That's going to be number one. It has to be number one, bro.
Number one. Good job.
I was going to say teen.
I thought it said teen as well.
Valerie,
yeah,
we'll
but
next.
I was
a
teenager.
All right. You look very lovely today. What is your answer?
Thank you. The internet.
Ooh, the internet. Is it on the board?
Oh, that's a good one too, bro.
All right, computer.
Computer.
Oh, wait, hold on. A computer is not the internet.
The judges have decided to allow it. Annam, what is your answer?
I would say television.
Television, is it on the board?
Don't pull my hair, girl.
All right. Three more answers on the board. Frodo, what's your answer?
Well, Rob, back in the Shire, we have a lot of hobbies. I'm going to go with tobacco smoking.
Okay, tobacco smoking, is it on the board? I'm afraid not. All right, Jufa, you got one X on the board. You got the first answer. What is your answer?
Hello.
Hi, Jufa.
We need your answer.
A bed?
Okay, no a bed. Is it on the board? Ooh, two X's. Oh. All right, you guys get ready to steal. All right. Mew, what is your answer?
Fucked up, man. Well, I know I can't live without my friends.
Without what? Sorry, say that again.
Damn.
Bitch.
Friends?
Friends!
It's friends on the board! Okay, here's how we're gonna do it, okay? We're gonna do this old school style where each of you guys share an answer and then Dan gets to pick whichever one he wants to do. Alright, so what's your answer?
Okay.
Music.
All right, music. MattBot.
I know Mimu said friends, but I think maybe socializing.
Okay. Jumbi.
Games.
Games.
All
Crumpet.
Bunch of gamers.
Parties.
Okay, parties. All right, Dan, you can pick one of those or give an answer of your own.
Well, now this is not my answer before I say it, but really what I should give is Twitch. Okay, that would be the appropriate answer. But what was the first one? I think music. I'm going to go with music.
Music, all right. Is music on the board?
I would have thought friends would be on there.
Good job! Woo-hoo! You guys steal the points!
Nice. Good shit.
Oh, so lucky.
All right. By the way, we missed the most important part because I'm a bad host and I got distracted by the game not working. Furry Booger with the 20 bomb. Holy shit. I need Dan, I need you to introduce me to your family here. Thank you so much, Furry Booger, for that 20 bomb.
That might be a little hard, since I don't know their name, so they will each need to introduce themselves.
It's RP, but my name
is Mr. Dementia. It's his dementia is acting up as all. Sometimes forget their names.
You've been using their real names. You've been using their characters. I want to use their characters. So my name is Gandalf the Grey, and I'm here from the Grey for this show. All right, and here's my good friend Golem, but I don't think he's on our team. I think he's just hanging out. He's just a creepy dude hanging out. We found him, like, rooting around
the garbage outside. We needed a friend. Sorry, we just brought him in.
And your name?
Oh, hi, I'm Jinbei. Hi, how's it going? Hello, this is my sword. Oh, is it okay if I just whip it out on stage?
Maybe you shouldn't. That is, Yeah. We're gonna need you to put that away, please. Okay. And you are?
I'm just Matt. I just walked in on the stage. I didn't know that this was happening. I just got involved.
Well, too bad. You're part of the game now. And then, what's your name?
Well, I'm Radical.
Yes, you
are. Southern Belle punk rock. Don't usually talk.
Well, you're talking now. All right, nice to meet you guys. All right, now, you there. Why don't you introduce me to your family?
Rob, my name is Frodo. Frodo Baggins. I'm from the Shire. Next to me is Jufa Baggins, my cousin.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, you guys can, introduce yourselves if you want, it's up to you. Next up is my other cousin, Mew Baggins.
Okay.
And then my other cousin, Valerie Baggins. Valerie, say hi.
Alright.
Hello.
Hi, nice to meet you.
And then my other... dog? Cat? Baggins.
All right, cat, dog, Baggins. All right, nice to meet you guys. All right, I need Gollum. I need Jufa. Please come to the stage. We need the next prompt.
Do you want to know the rest of the
Oh, yeah, where are the rest of the answers? Let's see what number 4 was. Video games. So
oh,
almost
my God.
How
did we miss that?
You got that? Yeah, Jimmy said it.
Alone? Okay, alone, I don't know if teenagers are getting alone. They shouldn't be. Thank you again, Free Booger, by the way, for all those subs. That was huge. All right. Not applicable. All right, let's get the next prompt going. All right. You two, shake hands, please. Okay, get off. Okay. All right, we're just waiting for the next prompt, you know? Hey, listen, the guys back there, they're noobs, okay? All right, here we go. Name a Christmas show or movie that is on TV every... Yes, Jufa.
Salami.
Is Salami on the board? Where is our board? Okay, name a Christmas show or movie that is on TV every year. Yeah. Gollum.
Yeah. Elf! That's me who says Elf!
Is Elf on the board? Where is the board, guys? Is Elf on the board? Okay, no. We're gonna have to go to the next person. Frodo?
Where's the board? How do I rotate them?
Ooh, this is a tough one. The board. I'm gonna go with...
It is an easy... I know exactly.
Die Hard.
Seriously, guys. Oh, Die Hard.
Yep, that's their answer. You gotta take
it. Is Die Hard on the board? Okay, Gandalf.
All right. Charlie Brown Christmas. The board?
Charlie Brown, is it on the board?
Charlie Brown.
Oh my God. Okay. Mew.
How could Charlie Brown not be on the board?
I.
Frosty the Snowman.
Frosty the Snowman, is it on the board? Okay. It is, but where the hell is the board, guys?
Where is
the freaking board?
Maybe the board was the fence that we made.
Well, roll it again.
Jimmy.
It's your rotation.
There's a backup.
Oh, fuck, bro. Hey, I took the fucking mask off. Relax.
Okay, Jesus, unfortunately, due to technical difficulties, we need to do another prompt. So come back, all right? You guys are playing another round together.
Oh, yeah, right? I got it. I don't know who that little gray guy was. All right, I'll handle this. So you don't worry.
Name a fruit that you can buy dried. Yes, Crumpet.
Peaches.
Peaches, is it on the board? Alright, for a chance to steal. Drufa?
Mango!
Mango? Okay, is it on the board? Alright. Mr. Wizard Gandalf, what is your answer? A fruit that you can buy dried.
So, raisins or grapes? I don't know what would be up there, but it's the same thing.
Raisins? Is it on the board? Grape, okay. All right, do you guys want to pass or play?
Oh, let's play. We're playing.
All right.
I am a players, baby.
All right, we're going to you, Jimby. Name a fruit that you can buy dried.
Oh.
It's too late.
I don't know, like, apricots? It would be
the apricots! Is it on the board? Alright, nice Whee! Answer, good answer.
Well, damn, ain't wages the best right now?
An apple?
An apple. Is it on the board? Okay.
Woo-hoo!
Rad?
Good answer.
Raspberries?
Alright, raspberries. Good answer. Let's see if it's there.
Good answer.
Can we get like one Steve Harvey look at the camera, like really disappointed, kind of?
I'm so okay, disappointed. Oh, I'm sorry. Looks like it wasn't such a good answer after all. Alright, Gandalf. We need two more answers on the board.
Cranberries.
All right, good answer, but is it on the board?
No.
Two strikes. Get ready to steal, guys.
All right. Oh God.
M Crumpet.
I'm so
bananas. I'd go with bananas.
Hey, no helping your teammates, guys.
He sneezed. That was a sneeze.
Yeah. Hachu.
I'm gonna go with bananas.
All right, bananas. Is it on the board? All right, you have one more Woo-hoo! Answer, Jimby. If you get this, allergic your to this team whole upholstery. Wins the game. Because we're not sitting here all day. So, and then you guys got fast money.
So, you know, when I like a girl, I take her out on a date. Is dates on the board?
A date. Ooh. Is it on the board?
Is that the same?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
A prune? That's the same thing?
Yeah, close enough. I think
you guys win!
Close.
You guys win! Then... Congratulations! Hit the music!
Close enough.
Oh, yeah.
Congratulations, guys! You
win!
Can we do fast money? Do you guys know how to do the fast money?
Something.
I think a prune.
Yeah, we got you.
Alright, I need two people for fast money.
A plum myself.
Yeah, good luck.
Well, our wizard leader, obviously.
Individual
Gandalf, who else would you like for fast money? Mr. Gandalf.
Oh, I don't know. You just come on out. Whoever wants to play, let's do it.
Do I have to reset the board for this?
All right, Crumpet. Congratulations.
I pick you.
Yes. All right.
Who wants to go first?
All right. Yes.
Go back to the.
Why don't we have
my wizard pal? All
right.
Now,
Mr. Gandalf, please come over here. We're gonna play fast money. All right. Crumpet, I need you to go to the isolation booth. Okay, get out of here.
Fast money gang. Yeah,
think about what you've done.
Fast money, quick money. Right. Have you,
Yeah, where do I look?
I need you to look. I need you to look forward. I need you to look forward there, okay? Just look out into the audience.
All right.
Look at all their beautiful faces. All right, so here's how it's going to work. The timer's going to begin after I finish asking the first question. You're going to try to guess the most popular answer for every question. There's going to be, I think, 30 seconds or 35 seconds to answer them all.
30 is for the first one and then 40 for the second person, right?
Okay, sure.
Mm-hmm.
Back group. Are you guys ready to begin this?
Okay.
Alright, there's so many people over there running it.
Alright.
It's four people.
Are you ready, Mr. Gandalf?
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Let's see if you can make some magic happen. Name a popular way for people to exercise.
Mm-hmm. No.
Running.
Name a place where you would bring a portable radio.
A beach.
Name a person who might use a megaphone.
An announcer.
Name a kind of rack in your house. A kind of rack. That's
good. Wine.
Name a kind of person who might wear a mask.
A clown.
All right. That's all of them. Let's see how you did. All right. All right. Let's look at the board together here. Bear with me. I don't know how good they are at being able to tally all this, but we'll see. All right. So the first question was, name a popular way for people to exercise. You said... This is usually where it shows up on the board.
How do I show?
I don't know. You tell me. How do I show the usual guy who runs this is on winter break. You said running. That's good enough. Survey says...
What? You have the... Oh.
You guys are doing great back there. Survey says...
You're doing great.
No.
We want you to validate you.
You guys are embarrassing me here. Just tell me how much numbers it is. I'll calculate it here.
30.
All right, 30 points. Okay, you're at 30 points so far. All right.
Working back here.
That's fine. We can calculate it here, okay? We'll work with what we've got, all right? We'll do this our way. Name a place where you would bring a portable radio. You said the beach. Survey said...
Beach with two C's.
28 points. All right.
So 58.
Nice, you're at 58 nice. Points so far. Name a person who might use a megaphone. You said an announcer. Survey said...
That's really good.
Zero.
Oh, I'm sorry. What? 0 points on that one.
How?
Name a kind of rack in your house. You said a wine rack. Survey said?
Also zero.
Also 0 points. Okay.
How could that be zero?
The people that made the survey was broke.
Name a kind of person who might wear a mask. You said a clown. Survey
broke,
said.
So I don't have a wine rack, so that.
6 points. So the...
6 points. Okay.
All right. So 64.
64 points. Yeah. Damn. All right. Can we bring Crumpet out here now?
And TNT.
Yeah. Hide answers, right?
Yeah.
Who answered these survey questions? I don't know. All right. Whoever Genesis questioned for this stuff. All right, there's Crumpet.
I think he just looked at the old episode.
Hello, yo! Murder Crumpet.
Into your
right.
Man.
Listen,
hello!
The amount of points that Dan got does not matter, okay? Because you're going to smash this. It's going to work. It's going to be great, okay? All right, it's a little bit harder, so we're gonna give you 40 seconds instead of 30. All right? And you know the rules.
Okay.
Where the fuck is this song?
I'm on
guys,
it.
Guys! Okay.
Cut the music, guys. Come on.
Our staff isn't too good at what they do right now.
Look at some pay cuts.
So things are all out of whack for me, at least.
I got this. Okay, I'll type everything. I got this.
All right.
I'm ready when you are, Captain.
Okay, we're just going to go during the music. You guys really had to play the full version of this song, didn't you? Okay, it's almost over.
I think he hit the closing.
It's a good
team.
Song.
Shit happened, right?
I did not push the mute button.
I meant
what is it still? All right.
Can't be standing up dancing, you know?
Next time, Dan.
I'll just keep dancing, I guess. Woohoo!
Name a popular way. What is happening? Guys,
is my time up? Is my time up? I didn't get to guess.
Okay, name a popular way for people to exercise.
Okay, pole dancing.
No, usually like this.
Name a place where you would bring a portable radio.
Date.
Name a person who might use a megaphone.
A coach.
Name a kind of rack in your house.
Your wife.
Okay. Oh, name a kind of person who might wear a mask.
A robber.
Okay. Good job. All right. Good one. Do you guys have that?
I was gonna say an ugly person. I have it.
All right.
How do you think I did? Do you think I killed it?
I think you. I think you might have messed up a bit on the wife part, but other than that, I think you did pretty good.
Oh,
hi, Jufa. All
right. Sure.
All right. Here we go. Name a popular way for people to exercise. You said.
No, I got this. I know how to do this.
Pole dance.
Check it out.
Pole. Hey. Survey said.
Zero.
All right, you guys are still at a exciting.
All my friends do it.
Points.
How do I type in the name score?
Name a place where you would bring a portable radio. Point. You said.
That didn't work out.
Square, square, square.
A date. I said date. A date.
Let me. I
survey push. Says.
Survey no said.
I didn't push anything.
Zero. Zero.
No, that's 17.
What?
Is considered a date.
Oh, okay. 17.
Yeah. All right. 17
what
points.
Is considered a date?
Hey!
Name a person who might use a megaphone. You said.
Who are these points going to?
A coach. Survey 14. Says.
That's got to be a lot.
14.
Okay. All right. Well. Total.
It might break 100.
Get the feeling I'm not going to win.
Points, if these are worth 55 points each, you've got this. Name a kind of rack in your house, you said.
95.
Your wife's.
Yeah.
Survey said. Yeah.
Zero.
I'm sorry, that didn't get any points. You know,
I don't understand this game, man. It was ridiculous.
I'm sorry. Your wife doesn't have much of a rack.
All right.
Guess I should have said like a coat rack or something.
Name a kind of person who might wear a mask. You need 105 points.
This is the one.
91.
All right. You said robber. Survey said.
17.
17 points. Hey. That brings you up to 112 points at $5 a point. You guys make $560. That's not bad. You guys
woo-hoo!
Get
it. 560 bucks. It's better than zero.
Now hit the music.
160
more.
All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Family Feud. Remember to spade your pets and neuter them to control the pet population. Take care of your families and take care of yourselves. Tune in next week where we'll be, I don't know, doing something. Christmas special or something. Take care and have a good night. All right. Gandalf, you ready to do your music performance?
I'm ready.
All right, let's get you a nice little stage to do this on. Let me think. What is the best map to have him play his piano on? Probably just our normal map, right? The Golden Gator map? That map will work.
You do that? Yeah, sure.
Oh, right, that'd be nice.
A nice stage.
All right, here we go. I think the mini stage actually has a piano on it. All right, here we go. Alright, so this is our map for our community, Dan, that I'm gonna drop now, this portal. And we have a little stage that you can play on. Here you go. Is the mini stage still there? Yeah, it is. Alright, guys, so before we wrap up for today, Dan's gonna do a music performance for us. God, I spawned inside of you. Dan's such a bro. Yeah, Dan's awesome. No GTA today? I don't know. Maybe not. We'll see.
I think I did great.
Yeah, you guys did something. You definitely did something.
The thing was so desynced, it's not even funny for me.
Am I a good operator?
You guys did amazing, honestly. I could not imagine a better group working that. You guys did better than anyone else in this
world. Was I a good Jalumpo?
You were the best Jalumpo I've ever seen, to be honest.
You're the best, Mr. Rhombus.
How is robber not the number one answer for person who wears mask? How?
Oh, we never said what the number ones were. We fucked up.
Oh, like who else wears a mask?
Always gonna be a
fucking
listen.
Ugly
beekeeper?
People?
Oh, no, that world's
doctor?
Broken. That's all I'm gonna say. It's broken. It's
just yeah, blame the world. It wasn't your guys' fault at all. It was the mess. All right, right this way, Dan. We're gonna go out this door. I think you just walked through it. All right, we're gonna go this way. And we have a nice little stage for you to stand on while you play your music. You can press the space button to jump up here. You just have to hold forward and space. Yep. Okay, so one thing before you do that, press escape and then go to your sound settings on the bottom. Oh, let me make sure you're doing it right.
Yep. Hold on, I have to change the microphone first.
You have to change the microphone. You also have to turn off world music so that you don't hear the music in this world. So
that's right. Yeah, that's right. Let's do that first. All right. Let's see. Audio. Is it under audio? World. There we go.
Yeah, world.
Just
turn that down
to
zero. Yep.
All right. Perfect. Did I change anything else or just go with the microphone?
Then you go down and you set to whatever mic you set to earlier when you were testing your mic for that thing.
And should I increase my mic output volume or wait and see?
Yeah, I would increase it a little bit because you are kind of low. I keep mine at 100%, 70% actually. So maybe go up to like 75, 80.
I'm going to do it 80. I did 85. And then
that's
we'll
perfect.
See how it works.
All right, guys, we're going to get a music performance from the Dan Man himself. Yeah, we can hear you. Yep.
You sound great.
But remember, you're going
to chat. Let me make sure chat can hear me. Chat, you hear me? Oh, no, I have to change my.
You're going to have to change your input to the other one. We're not going to be able to hear your voice. We're just going to hear your piano. Who joined? Who's Chewable Rose? What kind of instance did I make? Is this Invite Plus?
Okay, I think on chat, on the stream, I should be good.
They've been fine, like, since the dance world, I think.
Oh, really?
Okay. Now, why did you say you won't be able to hear their voice, only the piano, Rob?
Oh, I don't know. I just assumed that's how you made it. So, hit the piano?
No,
like, hit
no, I have it through a mixer.
Oh, okay, I'm done then. Just ignore me. Yep, we can hear that.
Yeah, I have a mixer. Yeah. So
I'm gonna sit up here and see you guys.
I mean, we could go up to the stage.
Now, I know I'm dressed up as Gandalf, but I think I'm gonna play a slightly different character here. So right now, I'm gonna be my character that I used in GTA role playing.
Like, skip the middle.
Oh damn!
I can play like Baby Birdie real quick.
Can I introduce myself here? My name is Merle Nelson, all right. You may have heard of me. I used to be a bit of a big country singer, but I've been a little down on my luck lately. The bottle's gotten me the wrong way, so I just kind of go around and play small clubs now. I appreciate you for being here. Any of the money you can give me, that'd be good to go to a good cause, and free drinks are welcome. All right, that's just what I'd like to say. So I want to thank you for being here and coming to the show. All right? Y'all can say yes, so I feel appreciated.
Oh, yeah! Let's go! Yeah. We didn't want to talk over you or nothing, you know.
A lot of validation.
No. Well, we're from the farmlands. We don't want to talk over you or nothing. We don't really know how things work around here.
No,
the Shire.
No. I need validation. All right. I guess I should start with an old staple that you'll all know. Okay? I think you know this song from someone. In fact, I used to play with him, as a matter of fact, but he has kind of done a little better than me. It is Take Me Home Country Road. Seems like a good song for this club. Does that work for you?
Yes, sir.
Woo!
Let's go.
All right. Well, here we go now. Thanks for being here. Let me just check chat to make sure They're not complaining about anything. A lot of times they catch me when I mess things up. All right, it seems like it's working well. So here we go. Actually, I'm going to see if the mix of the piano's right. I'm going to turn the piano. Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains. All right, how's the blend of the piano and all?
It sounds amazing.
Sounds fantastic, Bart.
Great, it sounds great.
All right, here we go.
You're doing your thing.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is older, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads take me home.
That's my CEO.
To the place I belong, West Virginia.
He's killing it.
Mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, all my memories gather round her. Miner's lady, stranger to blue waters, dark and dusty, painted on the sky. Mr. Chase, the moonshine, teardrop in my country roads. Yeah. Take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia.
That's my boss.
Mountain mama, take me home, country roads. I hear the voice in the morning.
The fact that he's Gandalf is perfect.
She calls me, radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road, I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday, country roads take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia. Mountain mama,
what the fuck am I reading in this chat?
Country roads, country roads, take me home to the place.
He is using Starlink, yes.
I belong, West Virginia. Mountain mama, take me home, country roads, take me home, down country roads.
Maybe he can't get any other type of internet where he's at.
Take me home, down country roads. All right, well, thank you.
Yeah, let's go. Oh my god, that was beautiful.
Yes,
that was really good.
Well, it won't be clear. Good, I really shit, appreciate, and as I said, free drinks are welcome. All right, I appreciate that too. I appreciate the applause.
Oh, free drinks.
All right, there you go. I love.
We get free drinks, or you get free drinks.
I can use them for some drinks.
That's all I got. $7 just for you.
All here's right. My sub split.
Well, what else would you like to hear?
Linkin Park.
On the country. Lincoln, I don't not sing any.
Yo,
Park.
Yes.
I have heard they're damn. Like a, they're like one of the.
What's your favorite? What's your favorite?
Give us a surprise. You know what's like what's a song you really like?
Well, here's the thing. I could pick some artists that I sing a lot, like in my real world, and if I picked them, I'd pick people like Zach Bryan or Tyler Childers or Sturgill Simpson. Actually, I do a good Sturgill Simpson song. That might be a good one.
Sure, either. Yeah, that.
That might be a real good one.
You know any Dixon Dallas?
Dixon Dallas. I don't know Dixon Dallas.
All right, we could go with that then.
There's Dixon Dallas.
Piano man.
And I do also do like some Beatles and things like that, but I think we want to keep it a little bit. I also could do like one or two Willie Nelson. I do like, you know, On the Road Again and stuff like that.
Oh, dude, On the Road Again sounds so good.
Do you know Concerning Hobbits by Howard Stone?
I have not played that recently. I mean, who doesn't know that song? You know, it's a big song. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the Sergio Simpson song, and then we're going to end with On the Road. How does that sound, everybody?
That sounds so good.
All right.
Sounds great. Let's go.
But are you so this Sergio Simpson song, Turtles All the Way Down, is anyone here familiar with this song?
We're VR chatters. We're antisocial.
I don't know that song.
Phrase Turtles All the Way Down? You know what that phrase comes from?
Oh, yeah, I use that all the time.
No idea.
The idea is that phrase comes from, I don't know which of the famous psychedelic folks in the 60s first used that, but he talked about when he was tripping that it was like turtles all the way down. You'd keep going.
Okay, maybe I don't use that.
Turtles and more turtles. So, hold on, let me fix my camera.
You think Dan Clancy ever just trips out?
That was because like the
song. So this is a song, and I have not done this myself. I just like alcohol, but this is a song Sturgill Simpson wrote about tripping. So I figure people here might like that.
I love tripping.
Right, here we go. I've seen Jesus play with flames.
Oh damn!
In a lake of fire. I was standing in. Met the devil in Seattle. Spent 9 months inside a lion's den. Met Booty yet another time. Showed me the glowing light within. But I swear that God is there every time I glare into the eyes of my best friend.
Yeah, damn, this game on KBS, he's doing well. Good for him.
Someday you're gonna wake up old and gray.
He's super talented. It's so crazy how fast he picked up on like the controls fun, and like fucking beating at pool.
Showing hope to everyone you meet and greet. And cheat along the way. There's a gateway in our mind that leads somewhere out there, far beyond this plane.
He did dance on me.
Where reptile aliens.
Yeah, tell him the 1v1 me in league.
Cut you open and pull out all your pain. Tell me how you make it legal. Something that we all make in our brains. Some say you might go crazy. Then again, it might make you go sane. Every time I take a look inside that old and fabled book. I'm blinded and reminded of the pain caused by some old man in the sky. Marijuana, LSD, psilocybin, DMT. They all change the way I see. Love's the only thing that ever saved my life. Waste your time on nursery rhymes or fairy tales of blood and wine. It's turtles all the way down the line. Into each their own do we go home. Other realms of souls must roam to and through the myth that we all call space and time. Right.
You killed it!
Let's go! You were great!
Encore! 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 Encore!
I tell you what, it's a lot more fun to perform with an audience rather than when I'm staring into the screen. It is fun to have people cheering. I think I might need to just make this a regular part of my stream. It's just
yeah, you should.
Yes. VR should.
Yes.
There's a lot of really good musicians. We could put on a whole show.
Yeah. No, I think that'd be really fun. Actually, the idea that now I just do my, like, I could easily see getting things set up. So I just, like, when I stream and I do music, I just do it in VR world. That would
yeah.
be a lot of fun.
Yeah, you can literally have people come watch you. We could set that up for you. We could talk on Discord yeah. about that.
Yeah, yeah. All right. We'll finish up with On the Road Again.
All right, awesome.
Let's go.
Yeah, we are.
Right, On the Road Again. Really just turned 90. That. Just turned 9. So, here we go. On the road again. I can't wait to get on. I gotta get my life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. There we go, I got it. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. Life I love is making music with my friends.
So beautiful.
I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again.
Fucking Starlink. Madge.
Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way and our way. On the road again, I can't wait to get on the road again.
Apparently Wampy got hit by a car in the first map.
Music with my
very lore accurate.
I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends. Insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. Life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again. All right. Now I'm switching back mics.
Woo!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
Someone get this man a drink!
That boy right there.
Woo!
Get him a drink. Get up there, LHP. Get up there.
Get this man a drink. That was sick, Dan.
And I need to get the right mic in here. Can you hear me now? How's that?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yes, right. Sir.
I really appreciate you. I appreciate all of y'all being here. It was really greatly appreciated.
I hope you had fun tonight, Dan. It was super awesome to have you.
Oh, it was a blast.
Yeah, it was really fun.
Yeah. Oh, and now there's a drink. I need to grab it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Cheers, yeah. Dan, to a fun night.
Cheers. It was a great night. Really had a lot of fun. And now I need to...
Cheers.
Now, I will say this. Coming and hanging with you guys is going to cost me a lot of money is the problem.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Can you hear me?
Look at the time.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, why is this costing so much money?
It's going to cost me a lot of money because of all the gear that I'm going to have to buy now.
Nah, it's worth it. It pays for itself. You know, think about this, right? Think about how much doctor hospital bills are. You're going to get into amazing shape, like the best shape of your life, because you're going to be in here all the time, dancing, moving. We're literally saving your life. You actually owe us. You owe us more than that.
And I actually, that's an interesting question.
Give VR.
Do they have people that train on bikes in VR chat?
On bikes?
Probably not.
Are there VR
I've
bikes?
I've seen the walkers, the treadmills. I've never seen a bike.
There's, sure, because I'm training for those. Any of y'all that are interested, I'm doing a half Ironman in September in Wisconsin, and some streamers are joining me.
Ooh, and that's so by my Chicago house.
Set up, there's this app Swift that you can hook it up to your trainer and you can bike with other people. And so I'm gonna start doing that while I'm training somewhere. You hook it up to your exercise bike, the one that you have, and then you can go on virtual bike rides.
If there's anyone who can do an Ironman in here, it's me.
Yeah, I bet.
Thank you, Frodo.
Dude, there are a lot of workout stuff in VR. Like there's literal gyms. There's Just Dance worlds. If you like dancing, like you could do Just Dance. There's so much stuff that you can do if you want to do stuff to get into shape.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Well. I'll just be doing it anyway. Just thinking of creative things. Well, Rob, everybody, this has been great. I really appreciate it.
Cheers, Dan. Honestly, you killed it tonight. You were so fun. You're natural.
My next visit.
Dude, I really hope. I really do hope we meet again, man. Have a good night, Dan.
For sure.
We'll definitely do it again. All right. Good night.
Good night.
I assume I'm gonna hit escape and then just exit, right?
You could just all F4 literally.
All F4?
Yeah, just make sure you have VR chat selected. Jake and Bake wants to join. You're too late, Jake. Do you know Jake and Bake?
Jake there now, Jake.
Jake wants to come say hi. So let's let Jake come say hi really quick. All right, he's coming.
Let's definitely do that. How do I put this drink down again?
Right click. It'll float.
There you go.
This mofo. Oh, okay, I'll go get Jake. I put you down, Jufa.
Of course, Jake wants to join now.
Yeah, where's this guy been for the last 4 months? He was actually here for the mute shuffle.
Oh, true.
I'll be right back, guys. I'm going to go get Jake.
Did Jake used to hang out with y'all in here a bunch?
Yeah, he has a mute. Yeah.
Oh, once upon a...
I love how there's people in his chat going, yeah, when fucking Ray turned around. What the fuck, Jake? Come join, then. Come join, motherfucker. Come join. That is true. Jake will only show up for mutes and the CEO. But yeah, chat. I don't know what I'm doing tonight. I actually thought this was just going to be a TOS interview and then the end of stream. Holy shit, Jufa. Hi, Jufa. What are you attacking?
Hello.
But I'm probably going to end after this because it's Friday. I want to
make sure they're not falling away.
Who's following? Okay, Jufa, I need one sec, okay? I got to pee really quick. Can you just keep Jake occupied when he goes through that door? Just tell it. Just keep him occupied. Just talk to him. He'll pay attention. All right. I'll be right back.
Okay, Mr. Wellness.
It's not letting you join. What is it saying, Jake? Here, let me personally invite you. Literally, give you a personal invite, which I need to find you first. A B C D. E F G H I J can bake. Please join the instance. Did you get that? The map is full? There's no way this map's full. It's literally 26 out of 80. All right, Jufa, you're in charge of the stream while I go take a quick piss, okay? I'll be right back.
Okay, Mr. Rhombus. Hello, chat. How are you? Are you having a nice, super oopy-coopy day? I hope so. It's not a wig, stop calling me! Stop calling me a wig mute, I'm not a wig mute! It's not a wig, I'm not bald! It's not true, it's not true! Stop calling me wig mute, I'm not wig mute! It's not true, but... Look, I have really fluffy hair and ears. It's so fluffy and soft. Look how soft it is. Really soft ears, like really soft ears, like they're really soft. It's so... Oh, stop calling me bald! I'm not bald! Stop it, I'm gonna get the skewy finger, I'm gonna get them out! I'm gonna get them out! Here they come! Watch out! Scary fangs inbound! So scary and sharp and lethal! That's what you can, you call me bald! It's not true, it's not true! Take it back! Right now! Hello. Give me salami, hello. Have some salami. Some jalapeno, hello. I'm hungry. Do you have a slice of salami for this little jalapeno, hello? Little jalapeno in the front door. Can you open the door, hello? Is there any tasty food in there? I know you're in there. I can see you, hello. Open the door. What tasty food? Stop putting spiders in my tail! I don't want spiders! No! No! What do you mean, no, honey? Open the door! Open the door! Right now! Open the door right now! Let this little jalapeno win! I want your tasty food! Right now! Give me the salami! Give me the salami now! Salami, now! No, stop marching, yeah, stop getting away from my tail!
Alright.
Hey!
Hey, Jake, what's up? Where the fuck is he going? What's up, Jake?
Hey!
Hi.
Hey, man.
You wanted to go say hi to Dan?
Yeah!
Did you say hi to Juf on my mute?
My man. Hey, Juf.
What's up?
Merry Christmas!
Hello!
Oh, you talk now. That's so cool. Hey.
They all talk. They're all a bunch of yappers. All right, come on.
Damn talkers. Where's the... I'm a mute purist, dude. I want no voice.
There's still a bunch of those. Hey, Jufa, you don't have to shut the hell up, all right?
I obviously can't detect the fine-grained finger movement.
Mr. Almas, teaches me really cool
sensors,
things.
Can you bring an object in, like a piano?
Don't tell him about
that. Screw it up.
All right, Jake, there you go.
You can't track the object, but you could place yourself in front of your piano and then sit at a piano placement like that, and it would be...
Dude, I watched Sam pole dance with Dan Clancy today. Like, let's think about that for a second.
Dan the man!
Jake!
Hey, Dan, you like my...
Oh, Jake, we're streaming together. I love it. I love your...
Yeah, we got the IRL camera here and everything.
Wow. I need to get I was thinking that I do need a 3D image of just me. So, and I assume you did that. You got someone to make that 3D image with your actual face.
It was someone in chat did it. I don't know. They were practicing their art and it just came out really
good.
Yeah,
well, they're catching up. Should I go open this box?
Most people in VR don't make an image of themselves because then they can't do all the crazy things they want to do.
I know, but I'm not.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna grab a package.
Be right
back. I'm gonna grab a package. I'm gonna open a package on stream.
Okay. So, I think actually, when I'm in VR chat, I can't do that.
No, it starts that way, Dan. But eventually, everyone becomes stage 5. Did you tell him about the stages yet, Murder?
What are you talking about, Jake? I don't know what you're talking about.
Murder? Just Crumpets, fine. No, we haven't told him about the different pipeline stages that are.
Okay, maybe next time.
Brutal.
No, chat. Tell me about the stages.
Here we go.
That's something that Crumpets good.
Oh, no.
There's different stages in VR, right? So when you first get in,
are you really going to tell him
so
the stages? Oh, okay. I thought you were going
to
tell him my
have
stages
to.
Of
he
VR.
Asked. Do you want to tell him?
I'm not telling him. You can tell him.
Let me ask, before we get to the stages, Jake, what stage are you at?
Oh, I'm
he's
nowhere
stage 5.
Near
he has
stage
a mute.
Five.
He has a mute. He's stage 5. I'll be right back. I'm going to open a package.
No,
I'm gonna got
like law. I guess it's out of time or whatever.
Thank you, Viper, for the 3 bomb.
So let me understand stage 1, stage 2, stage 3.
Okay, hold on. I'll stay in ear's length.
Yeah. Stage 1 is like your base VR chatter. You've just loaded up the game.
That's what I'm
your
doing.
Desktop mode.
I'm stage
out,
1 right now. That's what I'm doing.
Yeah, I'd say so. Then stage 2, you get VR and you're kind of like going around, hanging with the bros. You got a weird little avatar. You're RPN, having a good time. That's stage 2. Then stage 3 is when you get full body. And, you know, it's really fun and you can do stuff you've never done before. Next thing you know, you're in an anime girl avatar because it's like, I want to look hot. I want to be hot. Anime girls are hot. Then you get to stage 4. And stage 4 is like,
okay.
Oh, what's up, bro?
Maybe
you're in
time.
An anime girl avatar. Sorry.
Okay, you know what? Now I know where stage 5 is, so you don't have to explain to me stage 5. Okay,
yeah.
You don't need anyone banned here. I know what stage 5 is, so we can go without
so
saying now that I know what 3 and 4 is.
Bit of a
okay.
pipeline.
Watch this, Dan. Hey, everyone here in the audience, can you raise your hand if you're stage 5? Very nice.
I can't wear hats. This stuff does not fit my head.
It's Travambis.
Stage 5.
I just came
can't
to say Merry
you,
Christmas.
Jufa.
That was so cool to see you
I
here
know,
tonight.
Well, no, the funny thing is, if those don't know, Jake and I have been talking about doing a stream together, but our paths never crossed.
Here's what a hat looks
but
like
now,
on me.
Our first stream
actually, it kind of fits. No, it doesn't.
Here with you guys. That's why I figured I had to hang around.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
and
you guys finally get to meet
but
up.
Jake, you're just on a keyboard.
Now,
right?
Oh, my God, dude.
Yeah, I didn't set everything up, but I do have full body, which is really fun experience.
Stage 4.
Okay.
All right.
Get to stage 4.
Let's see what else we got.
A long way from stage 5. It's now.
Something's
like.
Big.
Narrow stage. In between one of those.
Yeah.
Supposedly.
Yeah.
We'll give them stage.
Yeah,
don't
take your time.
Sorry.
Just saying hi.
All right. Thanks for saying hi, Jake.
Oh, you're good. No problem. Yep. Yeah. Thank you so much, Dan, for coming by and doing all this and the interview and then hanging out in VR with us.
Mr. Wampus.
Really no, I just fun. Have a massive head. Here's a bottle of Simply Fruit Punch next to my head.
I look forward to getting to stage 3. I don't know.
Dan's leaving? Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Or if I will.
He's leaving, Mr. Wampus.
Okay, okay.
Needs to be as a different
thank you, Jufa. Thank you, Jufa.
So, you know.
Dan! Thank
yeah,
you so
I
much for showing up!
All right, Rob.
We love you, Dan.
So now I
you fucking killed it.
F4.
Yeah, all F4. All right.
Thanks,
go,
y'all,
Dan.
For helping
Bye,
me.
Dan.
Nice to meet you.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Later.
We love you, Dan.
He's gone for. He's never coming back.
He's never
coming
back.
Finally, now that
he's
gone, guys,
back.
We can start
so,
the real party.
No,
who was that
yeah,
guy?
Right, everybody take your clothes off.
I think that was Crumpet's dad.
What?
That guy was your dad?
I think it's that wrote Jack.
What? It was?
Hold on, I'm opening boxes. Hold on. Okay, let's see what I got in here, guys. Dan fucking killed it, though.
Wait,
Dan
CS
was
boxes?
Really good. No,
yeah,
AliExpress boxes.
Hi, Valor.
Oh, what?
Dude, whatever this thing is, it's fucking huge, there. Guys. It's gonna be good shit. Oh, dude. Ugh.
Nobody's a rogue.
Oh, dude.
Yo, XCOM.
It's what a up? Goku action figure!
What's up, dude? Merry Christmas.
Whoa!
Merry Christmas. Here,
it's sick! On. Look at this thing!
There's a lot of
Hold
new
on.
People. Look
oh,
over
shit.
Here. You got Silence. You got Mute Mew. If you just
dude,
look into the crowd,
Jake...
everybody's new. For
oh,
you.
Oh, sorry.
So most of these people are new to me. I gotta see what it means.
Jake doesn't even know about hey, what
Jake.
Happens here anymore, dude. Put in a jar.
Dude,
I don't know how
so
to open this. Come hang out sometime. We'll do a horror map together.
I'm only home for a month, but I really want to do some VR stuff, so I'm definitely going to. If whenever you're not doing
I'm
RP, at least.
Night.
All right.
Yeah.
We'll do something fun. I'm down to do something fun this week.
I was gonna ask. Are we allowed to see anime titties on stream now? Like, I don't know if that's a...
No,
can you give me the TLDR on that? Like, is that allowed?
You can watch people pole dance.
Okay,
we,
so...
Me and Dan watched
you
Sam pole out? Dance on stream today. That was sick. That actually happened.
What were they wearing?
A skirt and a shirt.
Oh, you're just gonna...
Okay, so no anime titties.
Me. You can't have tits on. No, it's the same rules as IRL, pretty much.
But have you seen the just chatting section? There's like a
bikini top.
Okay, what about
sensor bars on our avatar?
Yes, can we get sensor bar? Can I have a room full of sensor barred anime titty girls and we go around on adventures and scary maps together?
Any excuse, baby.
All right, I'll test it out. Does any avatar have sensor bars coming into the room?
Okay,
has one.
It's so OP.
What the hell is this for?
Sorry guys, my fish fell out. Here. Let me put my fish back in there.
They're going to a separate room.
There we go. All right, I'll be right back.
Ooh, spicy.
I'm actually there. Don't put it on yet. Don't put it on yet. Wait, wait. Let me just wait.
Yeah. Don't do it yet. Wait. Don't put it on. Wait.
Is that?
My pants aren't off yet. Wait.
That's awesome. I also have a penis. That's so cool.
It has like barbs on it. Yeah. Did
what?
You have barbs on
nice.
It?
No, but I have a skin tag on my shaft. It's kind of like a barb, but it's
what
softer.
Keep it down over there. Jesus.
So I guess we have a lot in common.
Do I get naked?
Just put it in already. Let's take so long.
Okay, hold on. Full screen? Yeah.
I'll make it should I get. Yeah, yeah. Are you streaming?
Hold on. Okay. Wait.
I'm not bald.
I don't want Rob to.
I think they're,
It's not true.
They're achieving stage 5.
Stop calling me bald.
Jake is achieving stage 5 in desktop.
Yeah.
He's asking Jimmy.
It's not a wig. It's not a wig.
What stage will I be right now? I've been in this game for almost.
Vincent, you're like stage 10.
Call me bald now. Is that on you?
Finally, perfection. That's how I want.
Wouldn't call that perfection.
Well, to me, it is.
Okay.
I'm a perfect freak.
Okay, sorry, I'm back.
Okay, this is
I couldn't
I'm not a pull the pain, yo.
I couldn't find scissors. All right, let's see if this thing's cool. I did buy that. Dude, that's sick. It's so big.
That's what she said.
Okay.
Looks like it's actually pretty good quality, too.
Looks pretty good. Holds well. Comes with a flying Nimbus. Cloud.
Ooh.
And some kind of bullshit here.
All right. Well, be careful, Robin. Might fly off.
Bullshit.
That's pretty good. That's going straight in the jar.
Wait, how is it so? Wait.
Let's see if I can place this.
Huh? Wait, what?
Wait, huh? In the lab.
Chicken Bacon's getting a strip show.
Look at that. That looks fucking sick. I love that.
Yeah.
Whoa. Oh my god.
Okay, I'm gonna get. I'm not streaming yet. I'm gonna get close. Bro, just to see like how okay. what the I wanna know what the range okay. is. Like,
just can't wait to get on the road.
The amount of people that
just my man.
Whole room just cleared out.
Oh, chat. That's it for today's stream. We're not doing anything else. All right.
I can't see anything. Yeah, you can.
So yeah. Hope you guys had fun. Wait, let me put on my headphones. Hope you guys had fun.
Get the pictures. Get them pictures. We can get them on live stream fails later.
Pictures.
Rob, you're missing the strip show. This,
you're missing the strip show over here. Jake is watching.
When I show this.
God.
Probably
room,
for the
we're
best.
Going over to the next room.
Extra Emily gonna miss me? I know. I messaged Extra Emily. We talked.
You know what? I just.
All right.
I just
chat.
A clip on. It's one of the top. Just
goodbye. What flavor juice? Simply fruit
later.
Punch. Literally crack.
Yeah.
It was rough. It was.
Raid Mori.
Totally.
Am I dying?
Okay.
Yes.
It must be okay. And we're digital, and it's art. So,
yeah. I mean,
all right, hold on.
I have that.
You're on my stream now.
All right, I'm reading Mori. Good luck.
I love artwork.
Oh,
I love artwork. This is so cool. Yeah.